job done this weekend. That's all you got to do. Survive in advance. One team is living that to its extreme right now. But survive in advance, and that's exactly what South Carolina does, Preston Thorne. And it'll be the fourth straight Final Four for Dawn Staley and the Gamecocks. Kind of what we expected. And we'll talk about this a little bit. And now, potentially the biggest game of the weekend. The entire weekend, men's or women's, gets played tonight at 7 o'clock. Evil versus evil.
I don't think it's potentially, sir.
Is it? You think
it's
so?
It's the one. It's no doubt. Champion, rematch, greatest ever, villains. Oh, man. It's a lot. It's a lot. And quietly, South Carolina just gets to go on the other side of the bracket and just let the other side just go through all this drama. It's awesome.
I had somebody ask me yesterday, this was actually an interesting quote, did Kim Mulkey's rant about the Washington Post article actually take some of the pressure off South Carolina, because it completely almost has made South Carolina a non-story despite how badly they beat North Carolina and everything? Like, this build-up for this LSU-Iowa game, did it actually take some of the pressure off of South Carolina in terms of just people paying attention and being like, oh, they better win or else it's a failure or anything like that?
Yeah, people stop paying attention, and also because what Brad Miller said, they're back where they belong 4 years in a row. And if we don't know anything about sports fans, we have a tendency to get bored very quickly.
Okay.
And so much like Alabama, Clemson, and on the football side, when they were playing each other, it was only 3 years in a row, but we were like, oh,
right,
again, here we go again. And so when you start doing this thing over and over and over again, you're not the shiny new object. Unfortunately, Kim Mulkey's wearing the shiny new objects on her blazers. So, you know, that's the thing that people are more excited about. But, yeah, you're right. There is a lot more attention on the other side of the bracket, which is just fine with everybody over here.
And that will really culminate tonight. Again, Angel Reese and Caitlin Clark, LSU and Iowa. I actually can't believe kudos. I mean, just – This is a great thing for women's basketball that you're going to have this game tonight, and you can say, well, people are tuning in for all the wrong reasons.
What does that mean?
That because they're tuning in because of personalities and not the game. You know what? That's what makes the game. That's honestly at times what makes tuning into sports all that much more fun.
That's why we watch sports. No, if you're not tuning in for the personalities. Maybe you are the person who's watching League Pass and watching the Indiana Pacers versus the Minnesota Timberwolves at 11 o'clock. That might be you.
I've done that.
Okay, that might be you. But all of us, the rest of us, we want to see Draymond getting kicked out in the second.
Tim choking someone out.
We want to see that.
Steph crying because.
Yes, that's what we're here for. We're here for the wrong reasons. It's called entertainment for a reason.
So the flip side of that is that, go back to the other side, South Carolina, and they will get North Carolina State, Preston Thorne, and North Carolina State is just North Carolina State basketball fans are just living the dream right now.
We did it first. I mean, it's cool. North Carolina State, it's cool, but we did it first. We did it a couple years ago, 7 to be exact, but we already did this. We've already done what North Carolina State is doing. The only caveat is that our women expected to be there, and I don't think theirs have. But we've already done this. You know, both teams going to the
we've already.
So we can give them some experience on how this.
Oddly enough,
works.
That was the year that again it was Phoenix for the men's. I don't remember where the women's game was 7 years ago. I have to go back and look that up. Just see, maybe somebody knows where. I want to say the women were in Dallas.
They were in Dallas. For some reason, Dallas was in.
Yeah, because I remember people jetting back and forth. Those that can jet back and forth, jetting back and forth.
I'll be back. I'm going to Dallas.
So tonight it'll be Iowa and LSU, 7 o'clock on ESPN. The winner of that moves on at 9 o'clock. Southern Cal, UConn. Sadly, that is like the JV game.
Yeah, it's wild. That's the JV game where you have. Juju Watkins, who is the premier sophomore, the freshman of the year, broke all the scoring records, broke Sharon Miller's record at USC. She's tremendous. And then you have Paige Beckers, who's unfortunately coming off an injury, but she was essentially the person that everybody was paying attention to before Caitlin Clark. So, like, that is a great game in and by itself, but that's just a basketball game.
Yeah.
It's just two women who are excellent.
Whatever. No personalities.
We don't have nothing for that. We don't
That's
want
what I'm saying.
For
no
that.
Personalities. So that'll
Juju wears a bun. You know what I'm saying? It's like You just balling out there in a regular old school librarian bun. We're not here for that. We're here for the drama.
So there is that on the men's side of things. Pretty entertaining weekend. Best game of the weekend. What are you going with?
How do you define best?
Kept you entertained the entire time. I think there's a clear cut choice. I don't know if you're. And it was not a Connecticut game because Connecticut
it's not them
destroying anything and everything in its path.
What's your choice?
Creighton, Tennessee, late on Friday night. Purdue, Tennessee was really good yesterday. Alabama, Clemson was phenomenal. I thought that was a really fun game and was into it. Didn't get much. The turn on the Duke North Carolina State game was kind of crazy. I was like, all right, Duke's. You know, I was waiting to have to come in here and kind of be like, oh, I was wrong about John Shire and Duke. They're not on the scrap heap. They're actually pretty gritty. And as I got a text from a college head coach yesterday, as he said, the softness of the brotherhood came through when it mattered most.
That makes sense. Yesterday, and it's always tough to gauge Duke. Was NC State America's team yesterday as they're playing this game?
I think so, and I'm not a huge NC State fan.
Is that how that works?
I've, for some reason, in that triangle of teams, it's kind of been I like either Duke or North Carolina better. I don't really care. I don't have a hatred or a love with either. But NC State would be third for some reason. I didn't grow up in that ACC football era.
Well, they feel themselves as third in that region also, right?
I believe so.
They're not the academic powerhouse that Wake Forest thinks that they are. They don't really get a chance to do the same things athletically as Duke and North Carolina. So NC State sort of feels like they have a chip on their shoulder in that area. So good for them.
But there was the storyline that really arises, although what was your line where Jermaine Cousinard?
Check his birth certificate.
You want to know how many years Jermaine Cousinard has played college basketball? 6. Want to know how many years DJ Burns has played basketball?
Check his birth certificate.
6.
DJ has the double whammy, though, because not only does he have the age, but he also has the size.
Well, I was going to...
And so when this biggin walks out on the court, everybody's definitely checking his birth certificate, 1,000%.
I was gonna ask you about that. Like, it's one thing to be Jermaine Cousinard at 25. Now DJ Burns will be 24 this year, so he is younger. He enrolled in college a year earlier, but he's been going through college weight programs for 6 years. And when you're that size, because yesterday it was just like throwing like the little rubber balls off of us. Like they're just bouncing. Duke players are just bouncing left and right. And DJ Burns is using the old man game. Just the hook shot from at like not even the fundamental hook shots. These are just like this is just old man at the YMCA.
Man,
just
what a sight to see.
Knowing how to spin the ball. But Duke players are bouncing off of him left and right in transition, and he's just flipping the ball up and making it. You know, the first two, you're like, oh, that's pretty cool, pretty funny. And then after about 6 or 7, you're like, he's got this down cold. This is a man who's figured out how to use the least amount of energy to get the ball in the rim.
It's called angles. He's just working all – he doesn't have very many strong angles on his body. He's a lot more rounded. He just uses a lot of different angles. They showed one jump shot yesterday. He literally jumped maybe 3 inches off the ground. It was very much, we talked about BJ Mack and his set shot. This is BJ Mack to the max. This is max BJ Mack right here.
He is BJ Mack times 6.
You think Lamont was licking his chops like, oh man, that guy, I wish I had that guy right there.
I don't know, because BJ Mack can shoot the 3. DJ Burns is strictly 5 feet and in on the back, but he was a monster yesterday. Great personality, good for him. But yeah, 6 years in college will make a little bit of a difference, especially when you're 6'9", a wildly underrated 275. By the way,
yeah. Let's I'll take the over. How about that? Let's get some. I know we're trying to eliminate prop bets for college players, but I'll take the over on that one.
That 275 was about 4 years ago when he arrived at Winthrop for the first of his 3 years there. 803-404-6100. Baseball makes a play there at the end of the game on Saturday to at least pick up one game in Tuscaloosa. All right, that's kind of the Ray Tanner adage. Don't get swept on the road. I thought it was a big series, but now you say, all right, you got to come back home and you got to hold serve here. We'll talk more about that throughout the morning. Jamie Bradford due up here in about 50 minutes as well. So a lot to get to this morning. We'll get a lot into what Dawn is dealing with her kids, as Preston says, met her match. Coming up in the next segment, I'll get a vibe check. We'll talk a little bit about that Clemson game. I got to admit, I was pulling for Brad Brunell, not Clemson. I know that that's hard to separate. I was pulling for Brad Brunell. I also, as Mark Sears was yelling at his teammates, yelling at people in the stands, as I was seeing Nate Oates, as I was watching Alabama, I was realizing, boy, Alabama's really hard to pull for in this situation. Like, really hard to pull for. Get your vibe check on how hard it was for you to pull. I'm sure you were pulling for Alabama, but how hard it was to pull for, and if you had to, like, shower afterwards late at night on a Saturday night after pulling for Alabama. 803-404-6100. Let's get out to the Love Chevy phone lines. Gamecock Larry wants to weigh in this morning. How are you feeling, Gamecock Larry?
Well, you can finally turn out the lights. Clemson, the party is finally over. Boys, every time the Clemson loses, boy, that makes old Gamecock every day better. Boy, I'm so glad to see you come home this morning on TV and all that. But let me tell you about these Lady Gamecocks. Well, I ain't going to say no more. No, I'll see you after the championship game. We're going to win it all. And another thing, let's see, I wanted to say something about Bill. Oh, yeah, Bill, glad to see you there this morning. I figured you'd have a day off this morning.
Oh, I got a bunch coming up, big guy. I got a bunch on the line here. I got, yeah, we got them lined up.
Okay, all right, go ahead. I just want to tell all of y'all, old game caller, I appreciate you all. I really love you letting the old man have a what am I trying to say? I really appreciate it. Love all y'all. Go Gamecocks. And we're going to bring it all home, ladies. We're going to bring it home. Don't go. Oh, yeah, that's what I wanted to say. That coach, Oregon State, I seen something a while ago come across the screen. He said something about the officiating. I don't know. I didn't see too much bad in it. Go Gamecocks. Bye-bye, y'all. Talk to you later. Go Gamecocks.
There you go. 803-404-6100. We'll talk a little bit about that Clemson game. Really fun game on Saturday night. We'll talk about Dawn Staley and her team as well. Interesting weekend. You're listening to Preston Thorne, Bill Gunner. She's Jen Jensen. It's the early game.
Preston here. Let me tell you about my friends at Absolute Glass, the premier glass company of the Midlands, offering auto, home, and business glass repair. So if your glass is damaged, shattered, cracked, or broken, they can handle the job. If it's a cracked windshield, that's no problem. They'll come out to your location and replace it for you. Yes, they will come out to wherever you are, whether you're at school, home, work, it doesn't matter. They'll come out to your location, replace it for you, usually for free, and to work directly with the insurance company to take away the headache. Now, if you're looking to increase the value of your home with new windows or mirrors, Absolute Glass will come out and take care of that for you too. Windows, mirrors, shower enclosures. I say it all the time, if you can see through it, Ray and Marianne at Absolute Glass can do it. So check them out online at AbsoluteGlassInc.com. That's online at AbsoluteGlassInc.com.
Taking a look at those traffic conditions out there this morning. I-77 northbound at Bluff Road. The right lane is blocked. Appears to be a vehicle fire, so caution proceeding through that area. Also, the right exit ramp at I-26 eastbound at exit 102. There's an issue there, so apparently the right exit ramp is blocked. That's I-26 eastbound at exit 102. Highway 602 at Enterprise Parkway, also a report of a tie-up. And as far as forecast goes, it's not going to be too shabby, at least for the next couple days. We're looking for a high of 84 today, breezy and warm. 85 tomorrow, and then it cools down a little bit tomorrow, 74, maybe some early storms. But it's nice today, 64 on the early game.
We will discuss the fact that it is indeed April Fool's Day. Jen has yet to speak on the program, which does concern me slightly. It's dawned on me. My chair has not fallen out. That's not an April Fool's prank, though, when your, like, chair comes undone or...
Yeah, it is.
I think that's eligible.
Yeah. Is it? No, I think an April Fool's prank is where you, like, hey... I don't know.
You got fired today.
Yeah.
But you really didn't. Yeah. No, it can be any kind of a physical prank or an emotional prank, a psychological prank.
803-404-6100. Can an April Fool's prank be physical? I don't think it can. I don't think it should be. That's...
Why not?
That's... because if that's the case, what this day is... That 24-hour movie that's out of... What's the movie where you're allowed to just go around and do whatever you want? There's no repercussions.
Purge?
Yeah. Hmm. No. I can get with the fact that it's a mental pranking day.
Mm-hmm.
I can be on board with that. I cannot be on board with it being a physical prank day. Because then we're pushing the lines of, yeah, this is the purge where you can just go out and do whatever you feel necessary and put it up under the title of, hey, it's April Fool's Day.
Well, I don't think you can be, like, I don't think ramming into somebody's car and saying, oh, April Fool's, you know, no. But yeah, I mean, if somebody wet the seat of your chair cushion, so when you sat down and, you get soaking wet, okay, that's April Fool's to me.
No.
Maybe have done that before.
Yeah, this is Jen's favorite holiday of the year.
But really
on the heels of what is
again?
And I was thinking this. I was thinking this. I feel like for a woman of Jen's stature, who prides herself on her pranks, April Fool's Day is like New Year's Eve. It's like amateur hour.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's like this is not the day where you shine.
No.
Because you shine all the time.
It.
Right.
Yes.
A true prankster is coming. When nobody's expecting. This is amateur hour for pranksters.
Yeah.
That's what I was suspecting that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But I like the psychological aspect of he's concerned that something might, because he just doesn't know. And I'm okay with that because I like screwing with him
it's
that way.
A big enough prank right there. No, I know that because I just opened up our cuts list to look and see what they were. And Tyler Head has put on there are no cuts. Ha ha. April Fools. They're on page 2. And I have to scroll down, which is going to be a pain.
That's a good prank.
Nicely done.
Good job.
It's more of a pain in the rear
no,
now.
That's that, no.
No.
Well, see, Bill, now you said we can't do physical. We can't do. What can we do?
No, it's a prank. I'm okay with that. I'm just saying.
That was a good one.
So, yeah, but all right. So we got that. But yes, 803-404-6100. Can April Fools pranks? April Fools. Be physical. I say no. I say no to that. It's not. We're not. It's, this is not the purge, out there for what you
it's,
have.
It's again. It's not saying you can go do something terrible, but you can do something that's a physical prank. That is, you know, just I don't know, putting some, putting some mentholatum lip balm on a door handle, things like that. You know, because and then where they can't. Somebody has to go to the bathroom really bad, and then they have that mentholatum on their hands, and, you know, yeah.
No,
so,
no.
Yeah,
No.
Those are fun
no,
things.
No. 803-404-6100.
Powder under the door.
For a lot of people, it felt like a cruel prank that Clemson was in the Elite Eight with an opportunity to go to the Final Four. Alabama gets the job done.
Thank you. Thank you for your service.
Mark Sears just explodes. What's your take on Mark Sears?
Interesting player. Trying to figure out if I would have loved him on our team. You hit the nail on the head in the earlier segment. I think Alabama's very tough to cheer for. Nate Oates.
He's very tough to cheer for.
He wears very nice sports coats, and that's cool. Seems like a difficult dude to cheer for.
There was the incredible flop. Did you see the incredible flop?
I did.
Which guy? I think it was it Griffin? I think it was Griffin that did that. That just magically, was it Gerard bumped into him and Griffin acted like Gerard had shoved him down. Mark Sears again is yelling at everybody. He kind of faked a cut there late in the game, and I think it was Nick Pringle who tried to throw a pass to him, and it was a turnover. Jack Clark ended up with the ball and ended up missing two free throws. Clemson, by the way, lost this game at the free throw line, right? 8 of 16 from the foul line is where they lost the game. Alabama was 15 of 22 from the foul line. I know that's a one-shot difference in terms of seven missed for Alabama, eight missed for Clemson, but 15 of 22 to 8 of 16, it kind of sets you back.
Yeah, well, if you don't take as many and you don't make as many, that's going to be a very difficult aspect, especially when you as Clemson, your game is based on being an inside presence. And so I think more so than the amount that they missed is that they didn't get to the line as much as Alabama did. So that's going to be a difficult mountain for them to overcome.
Especially because Alabama shot 36 three-pointers to the 26, although – It is a different philosophy now in college basketball, and
I think that's another reason why I don't love Nate Oates' style.
It's either at the rim or it's a three pointer. You either go to the rim, the ball either ends up at the rim. There is no such thing as a mid range shot in the Nate Oates system, which is why you saw 36 three pointers, yet still 22 free throws on Saturday night. Nick Pringle shot 13. Nick Pringle, you know where he's from?
No, I don't.
I did not know this. He is from South Carolina. He is from Wales Branch. Went to Wofford, then went to junior college before ending up at Alabama. Another guy from South Carolina that flew under the radar, played on Team TMP in the AAU circuit based out of Charleston. That's who Bruce Ellington and R.J. Slauson played for back in the day. But Nick Pringle, he was a monster on Saturday night. 16 points and 11 rebounds. That's a big physical kid, played 32 minutes. Alabama, this is the other maybe annoying part, has done a good job of kind of making a living lately off of South Carolina kids when you go back to Noah Clowney and now Nick Pringle.
Hopefully we're going to have to cut that off, right? That's something that we're going to have to try and cut off, and you know, maybe for whatever reason that wasn't happening before. But you see these guys who go through the developmental process as the college setup is set up now, where you play at a smaller school and you get to a bigger school. Hopefully we can catch those kids before they getting out of here.
But now you think about kids like that going to Wofford who've come out of this state, and there's some more that we'll talk. Ray Harrison, who's now in the transfer portal from Grand Canyon, I don't know what South Carolina's interest in him is. 6'4" guard out there, so we'll see. But 803-404-6100, Alabama holds them off. And that nightmare for a lot of South Carolina fans that was Clemson in the Final Four comes to an end. And maybe we get what should be an entertaining game. I don't know. Connecticut and Alabama on Saturday night.
Again, the more I hear Hurley talk, getting a little bit more tougher to cheer for him also.
You didn't like his comment over the weekend?
Well, at least he acknowledges that who he is, and that's fine.
No, in his fan base?
Yeah, I get it. So we'll see. We'll see. I haven't got my mind wrapped around that one yet.
803-404-6100, how you can weigh in this morning if you want to so do so. We'll get into a little more of Dawn Staley's team and what they accomplished. And as Preston Thorne says, has Dawn met her match?
She's met her match. There comes a time in everyone's life where you've met your match, and I think Dawn has finally admitted that this group has challenged her in ways she has not ready been ready to be challenged.
Well, we'll talk about that. 803-404-6100. You're listening to The Early Game. Bill Gunner for Love Chevrolet, where it is the Springtacular sale. That's right. The deals are rolling on. The inventory overflowing. And, again, everything in full bloom. So you need to head on over to Love Chevrolet to check out exclusive specials on Suburbans, Tahoes, Silverados, Trailblazers. You get the point. 14 acres of brand-new deals to take advantage of at Love Chevrolet. And, of course, with that $1,000 low-price guarantee, meaning you can actually shop other dealers, take their deal back to the folks at Love Chevrolet, and they will top it. The folks at Love Chevrolet will make sure you are in a great mood, a spring mood, when you drive off the lot in that brand new car, truck, or SUV this coming spring. So go visit Love Chevrolet, I-26 in Harbison, between Lowe's and Frankie's Fun Park. You can visit them on the web with their integrity, with their honesty. Trust me, you will not be disappointed. Get out to Love Chevrolet today, and together, let's drive.
I-26 eastbound at exit 102. It appears that the right exit ramp is blocked. So again, that's I-26 eastbound at exit 102. Highway 602 at Enterprise Parkway. There is an accident there, and a vehicle fire has things slowed down at I-77 northbound at Bluff Road, right there at exit 5. Forecast-wise, going to be nice for the next 2 days. Breezy and warm, 84 for the high today. Cloudy and 85 for tomorrow. Might see some early storms come Wednesday, and then a high of 74. But we'll welcome the next, certainly welcoming the next couple days. Right now, it's 64 on the early game.
How you can weigh in if you want to do so this morning. South Carolina women's team advancing to the Final Four over the weekend as they roll right along, Preston, as they just typically do now, moving on. They'll take on North Carolina State. South Carolina's now 36-0, obviously went 16-0 in conference, and really no problems whatsoever this season with pretty much anybody, and that is extended into this. Look, reminder, on Friday, they were up. They were up and in good shape, and Indiana comes back. South Carolina had to hit some shots there down the stretch, obviously, but South Carolina was up 14 at halftime. They were coasting, and I don't know if they, again, if that was a thing where they just kind of took their foot off of the – actually, they were up more than 14. I think they were up 18, 16, 17. But they were up double digits at halftime on Indiana, and then the foot kind of comes off the break, and Indiana is able to outscore them by 13 in the second half. But this is a team that Dawn Staley seems to be having more fun with.
No, she seems to not be having as much fun with this team. This team's having a more fun than she is, and I think that's the issue. They're good. They're young. They're fun. I don't know if Dawn Staley's having a lot of fun this year.
Let's let you listen to this. This is Dawn Staley talking about the impact of this team on her yesterday after the game.
I mean, this is probably the first time in my career that a team has more stamina in certain areas, like much more stamina than I could discipline them for. So I've learned to not fight certain battles, not core value battles, not the core principle of who we are and what I stand for, but just their identity. They're loose. They play free, and it's allowed them to kind of police themselves and to hold each other accountable. And so in one regard, I relinquish that. In the other regard, they're taking care of it. Like, but it's just different than I'm used to. So I give in to allowing them to be their silly selves. Like, they're really silly. They talk a lot about nothing, but some of that talk is holding each other accountable. They talk to each other like in some of the most unadulterated ways that we got to close the door and just kind of give them their space. But they enjoy each other. That's who they are.
Here.
Oh, I'm excited to see the connection on this.
Well, Bill, with 10 minutes left to go in the third quarter, the score was 49-32, and Raven Johnson and Camila Cardoso decided to bust out the Macarena. Yes, they were up 17 points, but there was 10 minutes left to go in the third quarter, and everybody was looking around like, ladies, I'm not sure what's going on. And I think this is what Dawn was talking about in that statement, where she was saying how that this team has more stamina than she does, because Dawn has reached the other side. It happens to everybody, where the kids are just stronger than you are.
Let's just all sit back and let Uncle Preston tell this, because I like where you were going with this. All right, so the kids are just...
The kids are stronger than you are. You can't resist them. You can only tell them no so many times before they ask again and just like, fine, here, take it. And she's been trying to tell them, like, hey, kids, we can't be this silly all the time. It's going to come back to bite us. You guys got to take this game seriously, blah, blah, blah. And they're like, all right, Coach Stanley, we're going to do the Macarena in the middle of the third quarter. And I'm sure she saw that and she was just like.
This was to start the third quarter.
Starting the third quarter.
And this is what I meant. Like, yeah, they were up 49, as you said. They were up 17. I said 14, mm-hmm. but they were up 17 mm-hmm. going into the end of the third quarter. Mm-hmm. And this is what they've done. They go out and they play basketball and they whip you and they know things. And they know things, and Dawn Staley's like, you don't know enough.
And they're like, yeah, we do. Actually, coach, we're up. But
clearly,
the game,
this is how she plays, how she says they are loose. Well, this is how they're being loose, and it seems to be working. You know,
yes.
If they weren't winning and playing the Macarena or doing the Macarena, that would be a whole other story.
Exactly, and it is burning a hole in her heart, because Dawn is from, like, old-school basketball. You know, like, take the game seriously. And also the team she had last year was very businesslike, right? They did everything businesslike. And this team's just like, nah, coach, we're doing the Macarena to start the third quarter.
What did she refer to last year's team as when she talked about them one time? She referred to them something like his business meeting.
Yeah,
and this is like a daycare?
Yes, this is the daycare. This is the effect that they're having. And I just love this video of them just doing the Macarena, starting the quarter. Little did they know the game was going to get very tight.
Right.
The game was going to get very tight. And Dawn's trying to tell them, like, hey, there's still a game here. And they're like, yeah, we know, coach. We got it. We got it. And there's nothing more frustrating than a teenager telling you, like, I got it.
Stop messing with me. I got it. Yeah, we're good.
I got it. She's like, you don't have it.
Well,
you don't have it.
And that was what was funny the other night after the game, was it Friday, I guess, where was it Johnson who made the comment something about, yeah, you have no defense for us. And she's like, in her press conference, she came back and she said, you lost a 20-point lead. What are you doing?
Yeah, Raven's up there talking about, yeah, you know, we're just pretty much unstoppable. It's kind of tough to be. And Dawn's like, we blew a 20-point lead. What are you talking about?
And doing that publicly, I thought that was great. You
I
know,
can
she
imagine
kept him grounded.
A lot. Dawn is talking through her teeth a lot with this team. Like, what are we doing? And you just watch the kids and you're just like, all right, man, whatever. Just going to let them be who they are.
And then what they did after the game yesterday was so much fun. With, you know, the Gatorade buckets
of confetti.
Full of confetti. I mean, that was just
and
awesome.
Again, they throw the confetti on her, and she's like,
aah! Well, remember, we thought this would be one of Dawn's most fun years, because this was a team that she was going to be able to play the, everybody's against us. You haven't earned anything. You haven't done anything. They don't believe in you. And it took 1 week to get to number one. It took one singular week to get to number one. And then the girls are instantly like, so Dawn can't play that card. And then they go on this run of, what was it, 15 or 16 games from Sunday, December the 10th, all the way through February. Where does it go here? February, where's the LSU game real quick? Excuse me, January 25th. Sunday, December the 10th through January 25th of not winning a game by less than double digits.
All the while, I'm sure they're clowning and joking the whole time, and she's trying to tell them, like, hey, guys, it's going to get serious at some point. It's going to get serious. Yeah, this is like the movie where Dawn has learned something about herself. The old Grizzle coach learns something with the new team and learns the meaning of life from the young freshman team. Shout out to you, Coach Staley. Welcome to the dark side. You are now ornery with the rest of us.
Preston Thorne, Bill Gunner, CJ Jensen. It's the early game. don't you forget, and there's still time coming up on Friday. We have the 107.5 The Game Spring Golf Tournament. It is this coming Friday. And, yes, we will be counting down the minutes, the hours, until South Carolina and North Carolina State take on each other on Friday night. It is the 107.5 The Game Spring Golf Tournament this Friday at Charwood. Want to see you out there. You can still register. $200 per twosome, $400 per foursome. We want you to come out and join us. We'll have breakfast. We'll have onion sausage by Old Timey Meat Market. Have a mimosa bar sponsored by Saki's Wine and Spirits. Lunch sponsored by Firehouse Subs. We want to see you this coming Friday. You can still register. Call Charwood today, 803-755-2000. That's 803-755-2000. It'll be at a 10 a.m. shotgun start. So come on out early. Preston and myself will be out there broadcasting live. We'll have giveaways, including baseball tickets, Carowinds tickets, concert tickets, craft beer passport, a lot of prizes for you. Call Charwood today, 803-755-2000 to register. You got time to do it. We got spots, a few spots available. Call, come out, play golf with us, hang out. And, of course, we will talk about that women's Final Four. Talk some baseball, too, coming up here in the next hour with Jamie Bradford. Well, let me get to some of the Firehouse Subs text messages that have come in. Beth and Lamar, just a page straight out of Jen's book. She goes with salt in the sugar dish. It seems like more of a pain, again, for the person doing it than to have to clean it out than the person that has to handle it.
Maybe, but, you know, it's just simple but effective.
It's part of the game.
Mm-hmm.
Ernest weighs in with physical pranks like exploding cigarettes or golf balls. I feel like Ernest with the exploding cigarettes is from sometime out of the 60s or the 70s. When you've got the exploding cigarettes, I feel like that's going way back.
Yeah,
that sounds far back. Like I said, I did the more simple but effective one where, you know, like the cushions that you're sitting on right now, takes a little time because it'll roll off otherwise.
Yeah.
But you just start saturating the cushion with water so that, you know, finally it all
when
soaks
it hits,
in.
It'll be a, yeah,
and then, yeah, then somebody sits down. And in fact, an unintended target is the one who ended up suffering with that for me, but it was still fun.
Todd, our resident Alabama fan, says Bill is 100% right. April Fool's Day is for words only, nothing physical. You tell someone something, they can't believe it, and then you come back with April Fool's. Todd also says Preston is exactly 100% correct that the reason Nick Saban retired is silly kids, not disciplined, not listening.
Yeah, it's just these kids. I remember the big thing that Saban was talking about. He couldn't get over the idea that kids were wearing holes in their jeans. He's like, when I was coming up, if you had holes in your jeans, that means you were poor, and we didn't want to have that. And now the kids are walking around with holes in their knees. You're like, what's going on?
Yeah, he and Joe Gibbs would get along well because Denny Hamlin came in after a win a couple weeks ago, and they went to put the banner up, you know, in the shop, and Denny's got the ripped jeans and stuff. And Joe's like, we're not paying you enough? Like, what's going on?
Yeah, it's just
no patience for
you.
It.
Just get to a point where the kids are doing stuff, and you're like, what? I don't understand what is happening. And I feel like that's where, because Dawn is so cool and she's so hip. And it's just, it happens for everybody.
I love it.
Speaking of Nick Saban, there's a really good article from last week on ESPN that talks about how he is settling into retirement. And there are some funny parts in there about how his wife is basically welcoming him back into the real world. One of the examples is she used in the interview is that during his coaching time, when they would sit down to relax on the couch, she would always get him a blanket. He is now required to get her a blanket.
It's fair.
I have a feeling I like her a lot.
It's fair. Miss Terry.
Also in the article, it talks about how he has now gone out and for the first time ever picked up his own prescription from the pharmacy.
Yeah. Hi. Saban. Date of birth. Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. I got to go through all of this.
S-A-B-A-N.
Yeah.
Well,
1, 2, 3, wealthy old coach drive.
Yeah. Mr. Saban, that's not going to be ready for 30 more minutes. You're welcome to walk around the store, do whatever you need to do.
Huh?
In the meantime.
But I can only carry so many groceries. How do I do more? What's that metal thing with the wheels on it? What's that?
He even took his first trip to the pharmacy to pick up his first prescription. He's actually quite proud of himself.
Terry, did you know that you can just walk up and they'll have your prescription ready for you? Isn't it amazing?
I have a feeling she's just going to smack him on so many levels because I've been doing this for how long?
Well, there's another part of this that's pretty funny with Nick Saban. Again, you can go check it out on ESPN. It's how Nick Saban is settling into retirement. Is this a shock and surprise now that some delivery people have had when he is the one answering the door because he's home during the day?
Hey, how you doing?
And apparently some delivery people have been like, wait, this is the Saban household? And Miss Terry is basically like, well, it's been on the package for years. It's
yeah, but I didn't know.
I thought it was his brother, you know.
803-404-6100. That's how you can weigh in if you want to do so this morning. Jamie Bradford due up next. South Carolina dropped 2 of 3 on the road in Tuscaloosa this weekend. We'll talk about that and look ahead to the next series the Gamecocks have. Texas A&M rolling into town. It's the early game. Bill Gunner for the Men's Clinic. You need to line up an appointment today, 803-875-MENS. If you've been suffering from a few issues, things you're not really sure of what's going on, and you need to speak with someone, what the Men's Clinic, they know there's nothing generic about you. So why settle for general medical care? At the Men's Clinic in South Carolina, they are the experts in men's health. So whether you've had trouble sleeping lately, maybe you're not recovering from workouts quite as much as you had been, maybe you've had brain fog, you're just forgetting things and you're not sure why, the Men's Clinic believes all men deserve to lead their best life, and that is achieving optimal health and wellness, which requires treating each patient holistically. And to realize that goal, they take a personalized and science-backed approach to men's healthcare that is professional, convenient, and confidential. Line up an appointment today to speak with Dr. Dan Balknight. He can help you, I promise. 803-875-MENS. Tell him Bill Gunner sent you.
The earlier accident on I-77 northbound at exit 5 has been cleared. Might still be a little bit slow, but it should be improving. Again, that's I-77 northbound at exit 5. I-26 eastbound at exit 102, still an issue with that exit ramp. So approach that exit with caution. And Highway 602 at Enterprise Parkway, still looking at an accident there. 84, breezy and warm today. Very nice. Mostly cloudy, 85. Tomorrow, 74 with some early storms for Wednesday, but certainly very nice. About 20 degrees warmer than it was when we got together on Friday. 64 right now on the early game.
Reminder, go to 1075thegame.com and register for the Palmetto Citizens FCU Grand Slam Giveaway. Every game, $25 is added to the pot. That's because South Carolina has yet to hit a Grand Slam this year. The pot is currently $700. No Grand Slams just yet, so you could win that. All you got to do is go to 1075thegame.com and register for the Palmetto Citizens FCU Grand Slam Giveaway. And at some point, when a South Carolina hitter rips a Grand Slam, you win all the cash in the pot. That's right. All you need to do is be registered. And again, how to do that? Go to 1075thegame.com and get registered. Currently, $700 are in the pot. And this coming Wednesday night, South Carolina will host Georgia Southern at Founders Park. The Gamecocks now 21-7 on the season, 5-4 in conference play. We'll talk a good bit about that coming up here in just a second with Jamie Bradford and get his opinions on the weekend that was, both from a baseball standpoint. Also, we've been talking a lot about Dawn Staley dealing with these kids.
Kids these days.
But these kids are going to the Final Four, and they'll take on North Carolina State on Friday. Joining us now, as he does each and every Monday, Jamie Bradford. And before we start anything, Jamie, we ask you the big question of the morning. April Fool's Day, is it just wide open? Is it the purge out there? Just for 24 hours, anything goes as far as pranks? Or is it only a vocal prank day? I side with you can only have the vocal tricks. Not Jen. Jen, across, thankfully, a wall separates us and a window. Jen believes it's wide open. If you want to get physical and prank somebody with tied shoelaces where they fall over and break their nose. Jen thinks it's open season on people physically on April Fool's Day. Where do you stand on this?
Well, I mean, that's a loaded question. I'd have to hear Jen's version of that. Like, she's not just going to walk up to somebody and punch them in the nose and say, correct, it's natural to punch you in the nose face, right? Like, congratulations. So
I don't think that's a prank at all, like, by the way.
Well, that's my whole point.
Well, I mean,
yeah,
it is a prank. It's deep with kids these days.
Yeah.
But I mean, I think that it can be beyond vocal as long as it's something that maybe it's something that the other party is already aware of, like in that relationship that you with it. Maybe it's like an inside joke you have with a neighbor.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it can be expanded.
A little something maybe in a locker room, some of the hijinks that maybe happen in a locker room or something. Maybe something like that could be physical. I was using a reference, Jamie, that I had soaked the seat, seat cushion one time with water. So somebody sat down, got all wet. Okay, that's a physical prank, but it's not hurting them per se. Pride, perhaps, but,
yeah.
You know, I mean, simple
it's
things like
than
that.
Attack.
Yeah, I'm not going to hide
it. Yeah, like you mentioned the locker room. We did that one time. We swapped out someone's cleats with another guy's cleats that were three sizes too small.
Perfect.
And they couldn't figure it out. I was like, man, this guy's an idiot. Like, obviously, those aren't your cleats. You know, but he didn't get it. So he was running around wearing cleats three sizes too small.
Oh, my gosh. Put some shaving cream in the end of their, cleats. Yeah.
Oh, thank goodness. Okay. I was worried you were going to say put, like, was it Bengay?
Oh, yeah, no. I mean, that kind of stuff you can do, too. But
isn't that the one that burns? Isn't that the...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I've heard. I mean, obviously, I don't know, but I've heard.
I think that's what I put on my shoulder, like, when I was probably in, like, fifth or sixth grade. I had pitched, and the coaches were like, yeah, you got to... No, Icy Hot. That's what
Icy
it was.
Hot,
Icy
yeah.
Hot.
Well,
like,
see, that's the thing, Bill. We are of the generation where the baton was passed from Bengay to Icy Hot. Icy Hot was new.
Gotcha.
Because Bill... It's not just hot, it's icy and hot. And that was the technological breakthrough of the time.
Well, when it went hot, I was not prepared. Sixth grade Bill Gunner was not prepared for the hot portion of Icy Hot. That was a bad experience. Let's just go with that. I feel like that was a prank.
Like Kevin with the shaving cream.
Yes.
Home Alone.
and I did not know what to do to get it off. I did not know how to finish that. But 803-404-6100. There's our April Fool's Day. We will not play any April Fool's Day pranks on you. And I also probably would advise you just to stay off of social media today for whenever people start figuring it out, because I'm sure there'll be plenty of April Fool's pranks out there. But baseball did occur this weekend, Jamie. We've talked a lot of basketball. We will get back into that with you, get your thoughts both on the national scene, but also on the women here. But your takeaways from the weekend as Carolina does kind of what I think you said 2 weeks ago, what Ray Tanner said, just don't get swept on the road.
Yeah, they made their best they made their best attempt to on Saturday. Yeah, I mean, that's the positive. You don't get swept on the road, and they did not. But you had some of the issues that they have been plagued with really throughout the year against stiffer competition that reared its head again this weekend, not being able to hit with runners on base until a little bit later in game three this weekend. The staff really, really struggled throughout the entire week, up and down. I mean, outside of Eli Jones, and then this weekend, Matthew Becker and Ty Good had fantastic long relief stints. You know, outside of that, it was really just not a good week for the staff. I mean, they gave up 39 runs in four games, and this was a coming into the week, this team had the third best ERA in college baseball. So you will have weeks like that. That's not going to be indicative of who they are moving forward. But it was a rough week, certainly on the mound. But they played better at home. They're 17-1 at Founders Park. And Texas A&M comes to town, a top five opponent this coming weekend, including Georgia Southern on Wednesday night. So this is a huge week. And South Carolina's RPI is really, really, really good. And they're 5-4, and when you look in those five wins, you got two wins on the road in the SEC, and you've got three versus the third ranked team in the country. So that's a really good resume, and they continue to be right in the thick of it.
Let's go back real quick to Thursday night, and you and Preston are more of the baseball guys in terms of the X's and O's, the schematics of everything. I know a lot of discussion. It's Thursday. I wish we would have had you on maybe Friday morning to discuss this. But the decision to bunt Lee Croy with first and third, and I believe there was one out. Jamie. I'm having to think way back now. I know that was a very controversial decision. I read what Mark Kingston said about how Alabama was playing for the double play, how the first baseman didn't even move, and with Lee Croy's speed, I think it was Lee Croy, could have gotten to first, maybe even gotten on base and maybe scored the run. What was your thoughts on that? Because it felt like that was a pivotal moment, even though it was very early in the series. I think it was, what, seventh inning, eighth inning, something. I think it was bottom of the eighth on Thursday. Your thoughts on that particular decision? Because it felt like that kind of set the tone for about the next 11 or 12 innings.
Yeah, I mean, those are always going to be really scrutinized decisions when they don't work out like you want them to work out. You know, but these guys, they have a boatload of information at their disposal. And so they're going to take that. They're going to, I know everybody is tired of the word analytics, and quite frankly, I am too, but they're going to take all that information, and then you'll pair it with the player that you've got and what he is capable of doing. And then you look at the situation and you look at how this can change the situation, how this can, you know, what would the positive effect of this be? What would the negative effect of this be? And one of the things that Coach Kingston has kind of shown us since he's been here is that he is not afraid to use the bunt in an unorthodox scenario to kind of get things moving, especially if he feels like it's only going to take another run or two to win a game. He'll use that. He's done it over the years. He did it again on Saturday with Gavin Casas, and that didn't work. But it also has worked in other scenarios. And that's just something that's in his arsenal. And when he has confidence in the guy who he's going to ask to do things like that, he'll call it. So, you know, I never really question those decisions because, you know, the staff at South Carolina, the staff at anywhere, they're going off of a feel that we don't have as fans or as onlookers. Now, it might be an interesting baseball decision. You might be thinking from a baseball standpoint, wow, that's an interesting decision. I thought that on Saturday with Gavin Casas, who was at the plate, he was 2-for-2. He had hit he had two base hits off of a left-hander, and he's hit lefties better this year. They bring in a right-hander, so at that point in time, do you go to Tyler Causey as a pinch hitter who sees righties better, or do you stay with Casas, who's got the hot hand? So Kingston stays with Casas, and then he asks him to bunt, which nobody saw coming. So, like, I was kind of leaning on the baseball gods kind of thing there. Like, you know, hey, guy's 2-for-2. He's seeing it well, righty, lefty, whatever it is. It's his day. Let him have his day. But, again, I don't work off of the feel that these coaches do. So I know it's kind of a soft answer, but, you know, I see it and hear it from their side. So generally I'm going to kind of lean on whatever information they have. I feel like that's probably the best information they have, but it just didn't work out.
803-404-6100. That's how you can weigh in if you want to choose to do so this morning. We'll come back. We'll get a little bit more in depth with Jamie on this baseball team and where he thinks they kind of stand here. 21-7 on the season at this point in time. What is that? That's 28 games. So, Jamie, we're a little past the halfway point. So we'll ask you a couple grades there as to where this team is at. You kind of talked a little bit about that. 17-1 at home, 3-5 away from home, but some nice victories, 5-4 in conference play. Obviously coming up this week, the Georgia Southern game on Wednesday, and that'll be followed by a series at Texas A&M, and that'll be followed a week from tomorrow with the game against North Carolina up in Charlotte at Truist Field. And it doesn't get easier. That's followed with a trip to Florida. So we'll talk a lot about where Jamie sees now as they really go into the true meat of this schedule. You're listening to Jamie Bradford as he does, joins us each and every Monday. Preston Thorne, Bill Gunner, Shee Jen Jensen. It's the early game. Bill Gunner for the Mortgage Guru, Jacob Crowder with First Palmetto Bank. Jacob is the mortgage guru in this market. I know that to be a fact because just a few years ago, he helped me get a great interest rate on the condo that I currently live in out on Lake Murray, and he can do the exact same for you. I'm sure things are a little sketchy right now. You're a little tentative on what you should do, but calling Jacob and finding out what your options are is the best thing to start with. 803-719-1005. First Palmetto Bank is locally owned and operated right here in the Midlands. So Jacob Crowder has local decision makers, which means quick and precise underwriting for you. And there's things such as if you are thinking about building a home, they have a no-nonsense construction loan that will fit your needs. The best way to find out is to call him. Learn how everything can help you. Call the Mortgage Guru today and find out what he can do for you. 803-719-1005. Call Jacob Crowder today. Tell him Bill Gunner sent you. the game. That's right. It's the spring golf tournament at Charwood Golf Club. Call today and reserve your team's spot. $400 per team. We'll have breakfast, we'll have lunch, and we'll have all your favorite celebrities from 107.5 The Game. So come on out to Charwood Golf Club. April 5th, that's a Friday, 10 a.m. tee time. Call today, 803-755-2000. That's calling Charwood and reserve your spot today.
WIST-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
Still working that earlier tie-up by the exit ramp at I-26 eastbound at exit 102. Other accidents from before have been cleared, and that's wonderful news, as is the forecast. 84 for the high today, breezy and warm. 85 tomorrow with mostly cloudy skies. It is, we might see some rain coming in on Wednesday. Early and a high of 74. Right now, 64 on the early game.
With Bill Gunter, former Gamecock Preston Thorne, and Jen Jensen. Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game. Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
Reminder, the craft beer card is back. You can go and purchase one. Go to 1075thegame.com and click on Sweet Deals. You can spend $30 at a brewery. There's 12 of them. The value is $360, but you can get this for only $79. Go to 1075thegame.com and click on Sweet Deals. Again, it's a $360 value, so that's basically $30 at each brewery, each of the 12 breweries, and you can purchase it for only $79. Go to 1075thegame.com, click on Sweet Deals to learn more about the craft beer card, which is back. 803-404-6100, how you can weigh in this morning if you so choose to do so. Jamie Bradford joining us as he does each and every Monday. And Jamie, let's start with, you know, going back again. You talked about the series this past weekend. South Carolina now getting Georgia Southern on Wednesday. Again, Texas A&M rolling into town Friday night. How do you grade what you have seen through 28 games? A little over halfway through the season now. What is the assessment you have of this team compared to what you thought, say, around February 1st?
Well, so there's a couple of ways to answer that. From a record standpoint, they're probably about where I thought they'd be. I thought maybe they'd be around 23-6, I think is where I had them. Or what did I have them through 30 games? 23-7, something like that. But they lost the game because of weather. So they're about right there. I thought that they'd be a little bit more consistent offensively to this point. Although they did, of course, have a good weekend last week against Vanderbilt and had a good Sunday against Alabama. They've had good days. There's no doubt about that. But I thought that they would be a little bit more consistent. I think we'd all like to see them be a little bit more consistent. That includes Coach King and Monty and Holcomb and their entire staff. Defensively, they're about where I kind of thought they'd be. They're really middle of the pack in the SEC. It's not a great defensive team. I think that they'll get better, continue to get better as the year goes along. But they're not one of the better teams that's been around here. The staff has overachieved, even with a poor week this past week. They've overachieved, and they'll get it right. They'll be okay. So, I mean, it's really the consistency. Like, you want to know when they play, what are they going to look like? You know, there's some days where you're like, man, here we are. This is that Carolina baseball program I'm used to seeing. And then there's some days where you're banging your head against the wall. It's very frustrating to watch very talented players not be able to move runners along. And that's not only frustrating for fans. Obviously, that's frustrating for the staff. But from a record standpoint, they're right there. You know, if you double that on the back half, you're sitting at 42-14, and you're a top eight national seed. So we'll see if they can continue to do that. But the schedule, as you pointed out just a little while ago, certainly is challenging.
What's your – you got something?
Yeah, so what's up, Jamie? How you doing this morning, sir?
I'm good, man. How about you?
I'm doing wonderful, doing wonderful. We kind of come from very similar baseball bloodlines, obviously sharing the coach of time. And one thing I remember from way back when was this idea of get them over, get them in. And we have been struggling with hitting with runners in scoring position. Is this an approach issue? Is this – are we starting to press? What do you think is the issue with this particular part of the team's game?
Man, you know, Preston, I feel like if I had that answer that I would call Coach King and – asking to put me on staff. You know, I really do think it's one of two things, and it's pretty simple. I mean, it really is. I think, one, you have some players who, like, it's a thing now, right? Like, we've all played sports, right? And when you have a problem that exposes itself, it's not like they don't know that the problem exists. Like, if you're playing football and you are 1-for-11 on third down and two or less, that becomes a mental problem.
Right.
Like, we can't get 2 yards. If you're playing basketball and you are every game shooting below 50% on, you know, at the free throw line, that's a problem. Now, shooting free throws is a hell of a lot easier than hitting a 95-mile-an-hour fastball with a runner on second base and nobody out. I can assure you of that, because you're holding a big round ball in your hand and you just get to shoot it. You don't get to hold that little one that's coming 95. You have no idea where it's going. So there's, you know, two different things, but my point really isn't the challenge of the sport. My point is the challenge of the mind. And sometimes you can't get out of your own way, so it becomes, you know, these guys put a lot of pressure on themselves. They put a lot of stress on themselves to overperform instead of just trusting what they're capable of doing. Like, they're there for a reason. You know what I mean? Like, does anybody really think that Cole Messina was selected a preseason All-American because he can't hit? And we watched him hit last year in 60-plus games. I mean, there's a reason why he was selected as the best catcher in the country. So, you know, these guys, sometimes they mentally can't get out of their own way. And then other times it really just comes down to approach, you know, just having being able to shift your brain away from doing what you want to do to doing what you need to do and giving yourself enough pitches to do that. And not to be strong and long-winded here, but what I mean by that is, guys, if you got a runner on second and you're stepping up to the plate and you don't have anybody out, You generally are going to look for one pitch in one spot when you're stepping to the plate, Preston. Like, when you were playing ball, I know who you played for. So right. I know what he told you. You know, you step into the box and you're looking for one pitch in one spot. And if you get it, you bang it. Don't right. miss it. You bang it. After that, you've got a job to do. There's a runner on second and you got to get into third. And sometimes, you know, with really elite hitters, you don't want to control them that much and take the bat out of their hands. But when you're struggling to score runs, sometimes you have to. So it's a challenge for coaches to really want to overcoach or make these guys kind of do more than you want them to do. But they're all very capable of doing all these things. They had a good week last week, but they still haven't hit their stride. This team is so capable of hitting a stride where they're literally unbeatable. And I hopefully it starts maybe now with A&M coming to town.
About a minute and a half left in this segment, then we'll move on to some basketball. But I do want to get your quick thoughts here in about a minute and a half on what you've learned, because you're a baseball guy. You love it. On where you see the SEC as things stand. As we sit here right now, I'm reading off of the D1 baseball top 25. Arkansas at number one. This weekend's opponent, Texas A&M at number four. Texas A&M, by the way, comes off a 4-0 week, so I'm assuming they'll stay in the top four. Tennessee at five. Florida at six, Vanderbilt at seven, LSU at eight. You get the point, Jamie. You know what? Your thoughts on the SEC and baseball right now?
it's incredible. Kentucky is the surprise of the year. Look what they're doing. They went to Ole Miss and swept them this weekend. Kentucky has these years every so often, so it's not shocking, but it just makes the league even deeper. Florida is the most confusing team in the SEC. Cannot figure them out. Can't figure them out. Unbelievably talented. Have no idea what you're going to get night in and night out. So it's a challenge. I think Arkansas is the best team in the league. I think Missouri is the worst team in the league, but Missouri is the worst place to play in the league. And so oftentimes you go up there, you fall asleep, and you get beat. And at the end of the year, you're going to have a ton of teams who have somewhere between 17 wins and 20 wins. I mean, it's just how it's going to be. They're going to beat each other up all year long, 16 and 20 wins. And this league will probably get 9-10 teams into the postseason.
As Jamie mentioned, Kentucky, the surprise of the league, they're 24-4, and at least last week jumped into the D1 baseball top 25 at number 24. They swept Mississippi this weekend on the road, 5-3, 17-9, and 15-1 is how they went about doing that. We'll move over to some basketball, get Jamie's thoughts on both the men's and the women's Final Fours. We know the women are heading in. We'll wait for Iowa and LSU tonight. While we know the men's side of things, we'll get his take on that. You're listening to Preston Thorne, Bill Gunner, she's Jen Jensen, joined along on Monday morning by Jamie Bradford. It's the early game.
The Game Network. The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5, The Game in Columbia. 100.5, The Game in Florence. 100.3, The Game in Myrtle Beach. Also on the 107.5, The Game app and streaming live on The Game TV. Yes, that phone in your pocket or purse will keep you in touch with your family and friends. It will take great selfies of you on amazing adventures or just this morning's breakfast. And it's pretty good in case of an emergency. But the single most important function of your phone is the game.
But both defenses have been this year. What's so funny?
The noise. You can listen anywhere. Just go to iTunes or Google Play and download the game app now.
The tournament is here. BetOnline is your bracket headquarters for this season with the best bracket contest out there and odds, lines, and info on every game and every round right up until the national championship. Head to BetOnline today to stay updated on all the action. BetOnline, the game starts here.
The Cocky Trot 5K and Fun Run and Walk, presented by Palmetto Shirt Company, is back. Join Gamecock fans on Saturday, April 20th for the fun-filled morning racing around Gamecock Park and Williams-Brice Stadium. Learn more and register today at GamecocksOnline.com/CockyTrot.
Introducing Herndon Certified. Herndon Certified used vehicles are quality assured and come with our 60-day warranty, complete with nationwide coverage. Don't just buy a used car. Buy a Herndon Certified used car and drive with confidence, knowing Herndon's got you covered. Find your perfect pre-owned in-store or online at HerndonChevy.com.
Herndon Chevrolet, Herndon makes you wanna smile.
Do you know the secret to losing up to 1 pound of fat every day? I'm Dr. Mark Bentley with Columbia Secret for Weight Loss, and I know the secret. Our unique weight loss program makes it easy to lose weight, get healthy, and get your energy back naturally, safely, and effectively. If you'd like to lose unhealthy fat without counting points or calories, no exercising, no prepackaged or boxed meals, no surgery, and no hypnosis, call my office now at 803-999-3020.
Leanne, a patient at the Columbia Secret for Weight Loss.
I joined Columbia Secret for Weight Loss program to support my husband. He wanted to do it. I've lost about 15 pounds in about 6 weeks. They know what they're doing, and they help you to make the healthier choices. They also encourage you and build you up through the process.
Many patients lose 20 to 30 pounds in about a month. That's a half a pound to a pound per day. For your free private weight loss consultation, call 803-999-3020. That's 803-999-3020. Or ColumbiaSecretForWeightLoss.com.
Bill Gunner for Dr. Dan Balknight and the Men's Clinic. Getting older is never fun. You start experiencing some symptoms that you're not accustomed to. Maybe it's brain fog. Maybe it's low energy level. Maybe it's lack of drive and motivation. But at the Men's Clinic, Dr. Dan Balknight is ready to help you with an individualized treatment that will treat your needs. So give him a phone call today, 803-875-MENS. Again, that's 803-875-MENS, or visit him on the web for more information, mensclinicsc.com.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential. but finding those people can be a major hassle. Unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. And right now, you can try it for free at ZipRecruiter.com/radio. With ZipRecruiter, one click sends your job to hundreds of top job sites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. And the results speak for themselves. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/radio. That's ZipRecruiter.com/radio. ZipRecruiter.com/radio.
When you have sports mixed with your pop culture, along with humor and celebrity interviews, your earbuds are enjoying the Rich Eisen Show.
Kevin Millar, we're all paying rent in Ohtani's world, right?
And the Dodgers world. Game is healthy. Game is good. And, you know, I get asked a lot, is that good for baseball? Yeah, it's good for baseball. This is definitely the team to beat, because that should be your next correction, Richie, is this World Series a bust for the Dodgers and Dave Roberts?
Hell yeah. Search for the Rich Eisen Show on YouTube or wherever you listen.
Hit us up on the Firehouse Subs text line, 803-404-6100.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game. Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
WIST-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
Clemson and Faro Road, we have a report of a tie-up there and still getting things cleaned up at I-26 eastbound at exit 102. The right exit ramp is currently blocked. And as far as your forecast is concerned, we had a nice day yesterday, a little bit warmer yet today, 84 with some breezy conditions, 85 tomorrow with some clouds coming in, and by Wednesday, might see some storms early and a high of 74, but we'll take this for the next couple days for sure, and starting your morning at 64 on the early game.
Talking about, sponsored by Love Chevrolet,
on your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
...803-404-6100 is how you can join us this morning. In just a minute, I'm going to play you an audio clip that has changed the course of college basketball this season in a wild, wild manner. But first, let me tell you about my good friends at Mid-State Roofing. Beautiful yesterday, beautiful today. But coming up, we're going to get more rain, and then we're going to have those summer thunderstorms. Is your roof ready for the rain? Have you done any leak detection? Do you have leak prevention going on so that your operation will stay dry and running well into the future? If not, it's time to call Mid-State Roofing, 803-356-1919. They have a 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week call center, and they are ready to help you. So give Larry Leitner and his team a phone call today and let them put you in a maintenance contract. For nearly 30 years, they've been the proven leader in the roofing and waterproofing industry, and Mid-State Roofing's proven history is your assurance. Their professionals will provide proper advice, service, and results to the needs of your facility in a both safe and pleasing manner to your operation. So call Mid-State Roofing today. Again, they got a 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week call center that's ready to handle your phone call right now as we speak. 803-356-1919. If you've got a leak, let Mid-State Roofing take a peek. Preston, Jamie, I want to take you back here to the ACC basketball tournament. This is Friday, March the 15th. Friday, March the 15th. North Carolina State is playing Virginia. It is regulation at this point in the game. Regulation. Virginia is up three, standing on the foul line. They are on the foul line, up three. Here is what happened next.
One. And he missed it. 4 seconds. O'Connell gets it off.
Again, that was Friday, March the 15th, Preston and Jamie. We are sitting here on April 1, Monday, April 1. North Carolina State would go on to win that game, obviously. They would outscore Virginia 15-7 in overtime, win that game. They would go on to win the ACC tournament. They would go on to win every other game played. And now old DJ Burns, the Stave Puff Marshmallow Man, essentially, is dancing into the Final Four, Preston Thorne.
I've heard him referred to as Shaquille O'Neal. What about Snack Randolph? Have a plenty of nicknames for my guy over here. Steak Griffin? Have plenty of them written down. We can keep going.
What is your take on this run? By the way, just because I put this on Twitter last night, we're all, Jamie, myself, Preston, we're all about the same age. I highly doubt either of you two remember the 1983 NC State run. I was not even a year old when it was occurring, so I definitely don't remember. But to go back to this, I said last night, this is the most insane thing I've ever seen in college basketball from a team that was not in the NCAA tournament. They were not going to be in. They have the most losses of any team ever in the Final Four. Jamie, here we are with DJ Burns in North Carolina State continuing to defy the odds.
Yeah, so it's a tale of 2 9-game stretches. They were 2-7 in their last nine before they got into the ACC tournament, and they haven't lost since, 9-0, right? So, but also, they're likable. Like, go back to bring this conversation home a little bit, and I know that the Gamecocks didn't win the SEC tournament, but go back to 2017. There was a lot of people in college basketball pulling for the seventh-seeded Gamecocks because they were likable. Sindarius Thornwell was likable. PJ and Chris and those guys were very likable, and they beat Duke. And Frank Martin was very, very likable in college basketball. He was tough and mean, but also, like, during that run, he was fun. And the country absorbed that, right? There's a lot of people absorbing this. Like, they're a likable team. And, like, you mentioned – DJ, I mean, he's a big old boy from the state of South Carolina. Part of that, that was an elite recruiting class back in 2018. I think he was the third-ranked player in the class behind Zion Williamson and Josiah James. So they're very likable, and there's going to be a lot of college basketball who's pulling for them in the Final Four. Now, can they win this thing? I mean, I don't know why we would say they can't win it. I mean, they've won every game since then. I know what UConn looks like. I know what Purdue looks like, and I don't know how you stop that guy who's 7'6". But boy, this has been a fun ride. I'm so happy they're in the Final Four. I'm so happy to watch them play in the Final Four.
Are you two ready for old school basketball? I mean, because that's what we're about to get. The plague that is Purdue, just Purdue and Zach Edey, tall, and it's just post players, and it's fouls, and it's elbows, and it's standing in the lane, ignoring 3 seconds, and DJ Burns. Like, this is old. It feels like, am I wrong on this? This is 1980s. Throw it into the big guy and let him cook, right?
Yeah. So you're going to have a tale of two games, right? Because you're going to have UConn and Alabama just tossing it around, and then these two guys. How tall is Burns? Is he 6'11"?
He's listed at 6'9". Mind you, he's also listed at 275.
So he's giving up.
Jamie, really quick. 275, you going to take the over or the under?
I'm going to take slightly over.
There we go. Yes, sir. Good pick.
the slightly over.
Good pick.
Let me give him the benefit of the doubt of the color of uniform, you know. Maybe I'm not seeing it well.
Yes,
so he's almost given up a foot to Zach Edey.
Edey 7'4". Burns is listed at, again, the ESPN Wolfpack roster has 6'9", 275. Edie, by the way, is also into the 300s as far as weight goes. I'll pull that back up. Edie's listed at 7'4".
Okay. Yeah, well, he's given up 7 or 8 inches is what he's given up. That's a lot, dude. I don't know. Hey, but you're right. It's going to be those guys down low banging around. It's going to be a blast. It's hard for me to envision UConn and Purdue not in the national championship. But stranger things have happened. And, hey, hats off to Burns because he's surprisingly quick. Like that move he put on what's his name for Duke at the end of the game last night where he went the other way and just kind of tossed it up there and it went in. He's got some footwork. He dances around.
That's a great description of his shot, just kind of tossing it up
there.
Yeah,
that is. Yeah, we'll wrap this hour up. We'll get Jamie's thoughts on the women's team. But, yes, well, yeah, they're – I mean, look, and it's fun to watch because it's not where it's ugly. It's not, he doesn't do it where you're like, man, that is disgusting. Why are you, there's a grace to it, a ballerina-esque grace to what DJ Burns does. And he does it with a gigantic smile on his face. And it's just annoying because you're like, he shouldn't move like that. Big guys shouldn't move like that. They shouldn't be able to do these things. We'll continue. We'll get Jamie's thoughts. The women.
Hey, quick question for you. Quick question. And just, we're going to break. I know that. Just think about it during the break. Are there any villains in the men's Final Four?
Yes. I'll tell you who.
Oh.
I'll tell you who.
Okay.
803-404-6100. Yes. 803-404-6100. You're listening to The Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5 The Game in Columbia. 100.5 The Game in Florence. 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5 The Game app. And streaming live on The Game TV. Powered by Integrated Media, The Game TV.
Sponsored by Shepherd's Glass, a true reflection of quality.
The Game TV.
Bill Gunner for the Ecton Law Firm. Are tax troubles weighing you down? We are in the middle of tax season. The race to the end is coming near. And if you've already received one of the dreaded notices of intent to levy or any kind of lien information that might hold you back and might cause stress, don't worry about it. Contact the Ecton Law Firm. This is where they shine. This is their moment. This is their Final Four. Call them today for a free consultation. 803-771-9800. Again, that's 803-771-9800. They have a local team dedicated to resolving your income or business tax issues for good because they understand the challenges that you are facing. That's why John Ecton and his team are ready to offer you peace of mind that you deserve. And it just starts with a phone call, a free consultation, and then you can go from there. 803-771-9800. Call the Ecton Law Firm today. Tell them you heard it here with Bill Gunner.
This is Boomer Esiason with the CBS Sports Minute. Danny Hurley declared, "I'm the Larry David of college coaching with my antics and idiosyncrasies." Saturday, the real Larry David was at UConn's blowout of Illinois. He left early, but not before yelling, "Shame on you, Hurley. Take those starters out. Stop coaching. The game is over." What Larry David doesn't realize is that Danny Hurley is relentless. I'm Boomer Esiason.
Planning for spring at Lowe's means big savings on outdoor power equipment. And Lowe's knows nothing feels better than free. Buy one select Ego string trimmer, leaf blower, or mower kit. Get one select 56-volt battery free. That's up to a $299 value. Power through spring with Ego, the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power. Because Lowe's knows home improvement. Valid through 4/3 while supplies last. Selection varies by location.
DQ presents... the sound of BOGO free Blizzard treats in the DQ app. It's the sound of downloading the DQ app, redeeming the sweetest BOGO free Blizzard deal, telling all your friends, and heading to DQ for BOGO free any size Blizzard treats only in the DQ app for a limited time. Download it today. At participating locations, limitations apply. DQ. Happy taste.
Yeah.
The young men and women who become United States Marines come from our hometowns to become a part of something greater than themselves. This commitment represents the highest level of steadfast allegiance to the betterment of our communities, our country, and our Marine Corps. The journey will be one of the most challenging, but also one of the most rewarding. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Hi, I'm Kathy Bates. People sometimes ask what I've learned in my two-time battle with cancer. One is that with the right treatment, you can beat it. Two is that it's not just cancer you're battling. You also need to anticipate LE, lymphedema, a disease that can leave those who undergo cancer treatment with a lifetime of swelling and pain. If you're facing a cancer diagnosis, discuss lymphedema with your doctor. With knowledge and action, we can learn and live. Learn more at lymphaticnetwork.org.
The Early Game
with Bill Gunter, Preston Thorne, and Jen Jensen.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach
and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
Alabama is a villain. Jamie Bradford. Mark Sears is a villain. They're elbowing Florida in the middle of the season in the head. Nate Oates is talking trash to everybody. Mark Sears will talk trash to everybody. I actually think it might be a good game. I think Alabama might be able to keep up with a Connecticut team that is just mauling and crushing and devastating everything in its path right now. Alabama is without a doubt a villain. And if I want to take it a step further, Purdue is just a villain because they're Purdue.
That's a fair one. And also, Zach said he's been overlooked by all these coaches.
Yes.
He's, you know,
yeah.
It's very tough being a 7'6", 300-pound guy. I'm sure there's nobody's going to take a chance on you. So he's been overlooked.
Alabama is the true villain. I was rooting for Brad Brunell, not Clemson. I know that those are hard to separate. I was rooting for Brad Brunell.
That's what we call splitting hairs.
Yeah, I was rooting for Brad Brunell. If there was a way Brad Brunell could have coached even Alabama, I would have taken that over Nate. Nate Oates, there is something about him that is hard to like. And I know some stuff from talking with high school coaches that also probably influences my opinion. But there's your villain.
I get Brad Brunell thing when I had my show on ESPN. We had him on often. Great guest, great guy. Here's the problem. I had a point to this. I know we only got like 3 minutes left, so I'm going to go short and sweet. Y'all can take it into the 8 o'clock hour and have all fun in the world. I think for the first time in a long time, the women's Final Four has more villains than the men's. Alabama is not a national villain. People on the coast of the West Coast don't even know who Nate Oates is. Alabama's never been to the Final Four. So how can they be some big national villain? Like, there's going to be a lot of people who are, for the first time, getting introduced to Alabama basketball. How many people are watching the Final Four that don't watch basketball until this time?
I can even answer that one. Do you know anything about the Connecticut football team? I'm going to go through. Yes or no?
No.
Do you really know anything about the NC State football team?
Well, yeah, of course I do.
A little bit more than maybe the national person does. Do you know anything about the Purdue?
Okay, I get your point. You're going off of Alabama, the brand.
People are going to look at Alabama and be like, "How come you get to have it all? Why do you get a football team that plays in playoffs and your basketball team also now gets to be in the Final Four when your football team just gets
there?" I hear you. But when you compare and contrast the women, South Carolina's a villain. They're in the Final Four every year. People have South Carolina fatigue. Outside of our state, people are tired.
Oh, I agree with that. Yeah.
Okay. people literally are beginning to hate LSU. And then there's a group of people that just love LSU. They love that. They think it's great. It's not a bad thing for the games, bringing attention to it, but it's pretty trashy. There's a villain. Now, NC State being in the women's Final Four, boy, this is a story. Raleigh, North Carolina is going to be bonkers this week. And hats off to Debbie Antonelli, by the way, because that's awesome for her. That's her alma mater.
Good point.
So I think the bigger villains exist in the women's game this year. The women's game, I think, has more villains than the men's game. Nationally, I have to separate being here where we are in the Southeast, what we know, what we cover, what we see, what we hear. Year round, the way that we're already thinking, the way that we're informed, or that we think based on what we have seen and been associated with. I've got to separate that and get out nationally. How does the country view the Final Four on both sides? I think the storylines really, from a villain standpoint, align themselves more on the women's side.
Well, Preston hit on this last year. Preston was out in front of this because there's personalities in the women's game. I mean, in all honesty, I follow college basketball, and Donovan Klingon, I don't know how to say his name. I was going to say he's the only one that I really know how to off of Connecticut. I mean, Zach Edey is the only one I know off of Purdue. I watched NC State yesterday, so DJ Horn, DJ Burns, McConnell, I can name a few more players there. Alabama, because they're in the SEC and I've seen them play. But you don't have the characters. You don't have the personalities. As Preston pointed out last year, Angel Reese is a household name, whether you like women's basketball or not. Caitlin Clark is a household name. Malaysia Fulwale is getting to that point. If Southern Cal wins tonight, Juju Watkins has become
She's
a household
dead.
Name.
She's in three commercials every game. She's on TV.
I know.
For sure.
So is a lady named Dawn Staley.
Right.
Correct.
You know?
Yeah. Yep. If Matt Painter walked into this room with two other people, you'd have a 33% chance of picking out Matt Painter. And that's no offense to Matt Painter. It's just that's what it is.
Same thing with Kevin Keats. We know Kevin Keats because he was at Wilmington. Like, he's a regional guy. But nobody in Oklahoma knows who Kevin Keats is.
Right. No, you're 100% right about what you're saying, and we're going to eliminate again. It is, look, the women, this will be interesting. South Carolina, NC State, and then it will either be, we'll see where it goes. Obviously, they've got to get out of the Elite Eight tonight with Iowa and LSU. You got, real quick, about 27 seconds, do you got a pick for the game tonight, and do you have a team you'd rather see win?
Iowa. Iowa pick, Iowa win, yeah.
Okay. All right. That's strong stuff right there, Jamie. Way to wrap it up strong, buddy. Hope you had a great Easter weekend. Also, hope you have a great week moving forward.
Man, y'all too. Appreciate it. Have a great week.
All right, brother. Okay.
Hour three's on the way. Thorns, buds, and roses. And I like that. Iowa and LSU. We'll talk.
Broadcasting live from the Herndon Chevrolet Studios. This is 107.5 The Game.
A great selection of new Chevys is available now at Herndon Chevrolet. The lot is packed with inventory and more is on the way. So shop your hometown Chevy dealer today.
Stop by or shop online today and see why Herndon Chevrolet makes you smile.
It's Jen for CHW Cabinetry in Lexington. Everything that we had to do in the kitchen that was such a nightmare, it wasn't so much of a nightmare when it came to picking out the cabinets because we had CHW Cabinetry. They gave us, helped us figure everything out, plot out the kitchen, figure out maybe some fun accessories that we could use. And then the photorealistic renderings, you wouldn't think is a big deal, but it really is because you basically had a picture of your finished kitchen before it was finished. And you could take that to put other pieces of your kitchen together. But kitchens, yes, they do that, but they also do closets. If you need a closet that maybe needs to be more functional or something like that, they can help. If you have a pantry that is just out of sorts, you know, you recently just found something from 2016 in there, okay, it's time to maybe get a more functional pantry. They can do that too. If you need a home workspace, they can help. CHWCabinetry.com or give them a call today at 803-520-6837. Be sure to tell them Jen Jensen sent you. CHW Cabinetry, passion from inspiration to installation.
Brakes for less. If you have the squeal, we have the deal. Get all four brakes for $239. Brakes for Less, located in Columbia and Sumter. Call 803-254-STOP for an appointment or just walk in.
Life matters. Okay, guys, I hate to do it, but some of us might need a reminder that tax time is upon us. Jesus knew what it was like to pay taxes, and on one occasion, he was asked whether or not it was a good thing to pay this tribute to Caesar. His reply was phenomenal. Taking a Roman coin in hand, he asked, "Whose image is on the money?" The answer, of course, was Caesar's. Jesus then said, "Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and likewise give to God what belongs to God." His point was clear. The coin belongs to Caesar because it bears his image. You and I belong to God because we bear his image. So as you get ready to send in that return, remember something even more important. Remember to honor and obey God, for you've been made in his image. This is Pastor Stephen Chitty of Christian Life. Visit us on the web at ChristianLifeColumbia.com. And remember, life matters, and so do you.
What you're talking about.
Brought to you by Love Chevy, where the inventory's overflowing and the deals are in full bloom. I-26 at Harbison and at LoveChevy.com. Together, let's drive. Got something to say?
Ring us up on the Love Chevy phone line. South Carolina's number one volume Chevy dealer.
At 803-404-6100.
Your home of the Gamecocks. 107.5 The Game.
For Fi, winning the fight against vision loss means seeing new ways to push himself. The Foundation Fighting Blindness is committed to funding research to end blinding retinal diseases. The Foundation Fighting Blindness. Together, we're winning. Learn more at fightingblindness.org.
WIST-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
For your Monday morning commute, we are seeing just a couple things out there to make you aware of. Clemson Road at Farrow Road, also Hardscrabble at Elders Pond Road. I-20 both east and westbound at Broad River Road. The traffic light's currently malfunctioning, so just be patient. Follow those laws that we learned in driving school or driver's ed. But again, that's I-20 both east and westbound there at Broad River Road. The traffic lights are malfunctioning. Looking for a great day today. 84, breezy and warm. 85 tomorrow. Maybe some rain on Wednesday.
WNKT-FM, Eastover, Columbia.
Hey, this is South Carolina DQ Smith. You listen to 107.5 The Game, the home of the Gamecocks.
A Cumulus Media station.
The Early Game.
With Bill Gunter, former Gamecock Preston Thorne, and Jen Jensen.
It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. It was the epoch of belief and the epoch of incredulity. It was the season of light, the season of darkness. It was the spring of hope. It was the winter of despair. That, folks, is Charles Dickens predicting the Gamecock fate on Saturday. A tale of two halves, Bill.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia. 107.5 The Game.
Interesting way to open the program there with a little Charles Dickinson reading for you.
So I'm sorry, who?
Is it, what is his last name? I don't know.
Charles Dickens.
Dickens. Yeah, it's not Dickinson?
Not Dickinson.
No. Okay, yeah, I don't read.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach.
The theme of this show. I don't know. Oh, what happened?
And 100.5 The Game in Florence.
They're not going to foul. Gamecocks are going to dribble out the clock. South Carolina is back where they belong. The Gamecocks are in the Final Four for the fourth consecutive year and sixth time in 10 seasons. Gamecocks knock off Oregon State 70-58. We're headed to Cleveland. The Gamecocks are on the way to the Final Four. Crowd on their feet. Celebration around the bench. The Gamecocks hold off the 12th-ranked Beavers. And the season continues. For the fourth straight year, the Gamecocks are in the Final Four.
That was the call yesterday from Brad Muller as the Gamecocks advance. Fourth straight Final Four, 70-58. Gamecocks roll over Oregon State. The Oregon State coach did complain about officiating.
All right, man, that's what's up. Congratulations, sir. I don't know what to tell you, man.
He did want to whine a little bit about officiating and how calls affected the game, affected his team. He was not happy, but South Carolina gets the job done.
That's not a good look. That's not a good look for a coach to complain after the game about officiating. When you look at it, yes, his team did get into some foul trouble throughout the game, but that was because they were being aggressive down low. Also, Camilla was in a little bit of foul trouble also. So, I mean, the game was officiated very tightly, a little bit more tight than I would have liked.
Okay.
But that was what the game was. I don't know what to tell you, dawg.
Yesterday, the box score for the Gamecocks, you just mentioned Camilla Cardoso, 26 minutes, 12 points, 9 rebounds, dominated the boards for her, did not have a block, which is a little surprising. Ashlyn Watkins, though, took care of the blocking. 4 blocks for Ashlyn Watkins, who comes off the bench, 27 minutes played, 8 points, 14 rebounds, 4 blocks for her.
All of that was impressive, but the most impressive thing was she was very close to getting a tip-in dunk. I mean, extremely close to getting the tip-in dunk. It almost happened, but Ashlyn was coming off the bench. They switched the lineup a little bit. She came off the bench, provided a spark not only on offense but specifically on defense with being able to block the ball and bringing that extra energy. It was a really great game. I believe she was probably the catalyst for the team yesterday.
It also goes to show that South Carolina can win in different ways because – Remember, all year long we've talked about they need shooting. This was what cost them last year against Iowa. They don't have three-point shooting. They've got to have three-point shooting. They were 4 of 20 yesterday from three-point range. Tahina Pau-Pau was 1 of 7. The Gamecocks did this not making three-pointers. Oregon State, by the way, was 8 of 25. But the Gamecocks 4 of 20 from three-point range and still win by 12.
They did not make a lot, but when it was crucial time,
the game came down,
they made 2 back-to-back, and especially Raven making one in that corner, which was a big difference from where we were last year. So, yeah, they did not make as many, but when the time came, they made them in the timely moments.
22 offensive rebounds for South Carolina. This is a stat that's pretty typical in a South Carolina game. 22 offensive rebounds to just 7 for Oregon State also yesterday. And the Gamecocks move on tonight, though. This is interesting to me to see how we all as sports fans look at Caitlin Clark and Angel Reese, because this is last year. They're for us, we're not, I assume most of you listening are not Iowa or LSU fans. To us, they're both annoying. And who would you rather, that's what I asked Jamie Bradford, who would you rather see win tonight? Who would you kind of, out of those two, who would you rather get the revenge on Iowa? Would you rather knock out Caitlin Clark? Or would you rather for a 19th time knock off LSU and get another victory over Kim Mulkey and Angel Reese and all that? Who would you rather go with? Now, it's been brought up over the weekend that the rivalry between Clark and Reese, I don't really know what rivalry there is. They've only played each other once, to my knowledge. And in that game, Angel Reese won a national championship and basically did the face thing back to Caitlin Clark.
Come on, give it the proper respect. She did the Tony Yayo / John Cena, you can't see me.
Okay, all right.
If we're going to do a sports show, Bill, we have to have, I don't care about any statistics that you name, but if we're going to talk sports, it was the Tony Yayo / John Cena, you can't see me.
So
That's what it was. Let's be clear.
Let's get the back-to-back here, Jen. I've called for 17. This is Caitlin Clark. This is first, we're going to go with Caitlin Clark on the rivalry with Angel Reese, and then we'll flip it and go with the Angel Reese on the rivalry with Caitlin Clark. Here is Caitlin Clark on the rivalry with Angel Reese.
Yeah, I think like you said, there's definitely that competitive fire. You know, both of us want to win more than anything, and that's how it should be when you're a competitor and you get into a situation like this, you know, whether it was the national championship, whether it's Elite Eight, that goes for LSU's entire roster, that goes for Iowa's entire roster. Every single one of us want this so bad. We want to advance to the Final Four so bad. So I think that's the main similarity, is how bad and how competitive we are. And, you know, we both grew up loving this game, and we're going to do anything we can to help our teams win.
So that's Caitlin Clark's side of it. That's Caitlin Clark. Here is Angel Reese on the rivalry with Caitlin Clark.
Don't hate each other. Like, I want everybody to understand that it's just a super competitive game. And, like, I just wish people realize that, like, once I get between those lines, it's no friends. I have plenty of friends on the court that I talk to outside of the game, but like when I get between those lines, like we're not friends, we're not buddies. I'm gonna talk trash to you, I'm gonna do whatever it takes to get in your head the whole entire game, but after the game we can kick it. Like, I don't think people really realize that, and that's fine. I'll take the villain role, I'll take the hit for it, but I know we're going women's basketball, and if this is the way we're gonna do it, then this is the way we're gonna do it. You like it or you don't.
You ready for this? The one time I actually respect Angel Reese and like what she said.
Okay.
Because I do feel like I was really scouting. I wasn't a part of it, but I was in basketball more so than I am now, 10, 12 years ago, when everybody was mad at the buddy, 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 banana boat, Bahama ride with Chris Paul.
What is everybody's main complaint? Everybody always says, oh, these guys get along. What happened to the days when I didn't like the teammates? But now, all of a sudden, when the women do it, oh, it's too much. Oh, we can't have them going against each other. Yes, it is a sport. We do not, we're not required to shake hands with our friends on the, get out of here.
Exactly. That was the one time I saw that from Angel Reese, and I thought, okay, I actually kind of like, if you're just, when you're being dead on it, which she was, and she's right about growing the women's game. She's right. And South Carolina, Aaliyah Boston, And as Joe says, Ashlyn Swatkins and Malaysia Fulwiley, South Carolina is playing a large role. Dawn Staley is playing a large role in this too. They are growing the game. And that is something that Angel Reese should actually be proud of. And Caitlin Clark, I mean, legitimately like proud of that they are developing that game. But what Angel Reese said there about that, I actually went, that's a competitor. I actually kind of respect that.
It's the same thing that Caitlin said on the other side. Yeah, we're both trying to win. We are being highly competitive. I'm sorry if the idea of two women on a court being competitive, if that somehow ruffles you, your feathers the wrong way, but that's what it is. And again, when you contrast that to what the main complaints we all have about basketball, it's the AAU system. Everybody's too buddy-buddy now. Well, look, now we got some folks that are willing to go out there and compete, and it's the two of the women at the top of the game rematching the national championship from last year. What else could you want?
Charlie D says he wants Iowa to win. Hard to beat one team three times in the same year.
That's a good point.
He says that he believes LSU is the more complete team as opposed to Iowa as well.
Yeah, I do agree with that. The only issue I have playing Iowa from a strategical standpoint is that they're very good on the three ball, and we have not defended the three ball very well. So that would be my strategical standpoint.
There you go. 803-404-6100. Now, on the flip side of that, you've got, as several of y'all are weighing in, AJ says, Dan Hurley is a personality. Nate Oates is a villain. DJ Burns has captured the nation's imagination for whatever reason. Some people hate Zach Edey, but y'all are correct. The women's tournament has more of this.
Oh, it's not whatever reason. DJ Burns has captured imagination because he's 300 pounds and he's doing pirouettes out there. We don't see this very often. We love this. Everybody loves the big, hefty baller. This guy's likable, man. There's a very specific reason why we like this guy.
And that's very true. And again, I don't know how I feel about it. Like, what, you know, is this goes back to what we wrapped up the show with last week. Okay? Last Friday, you weren't a fan, if I understand. I was going back and looking at the notes. You weren't a fan of this past weekend. You're more excited about the Final Four.
Correct.
I, on the flip side, I'm kind of like, all right, well, what game excites me the most? What game do I say, whew, Monday night, I'm willing to stay up till 9:30. I'm now going to make the effort to stay up till 11:30. I'm now going to make the effort to stay out an extra 15 minutes and catch one shining moment. What game excites me on the men's side? You got one of those?
Only if DJ Burns advances.
So, see, that's it for you.
That's me, yeah.
And that's what I'm saying. This weekend, and then you toss in the incredibly late start time a week from tonight.
You may have a point.
This is the cut. I'm cut. I don't. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Purdue and NC State. I mean, if it wasn't the Final Four, are you sitting down on a Tuesday night in December or January to watch Purdue and NC State?
Nah. No, zero chance, actually. literally zero chance.
even if... You knew all about DJ Burns, and you were like, hey, DJ Burns and Zach Edey, are you sitting? No, if you're not a fan of those.
No, teams. I've known about Zach Edey, and I've consciously decided, like, eh, I think I'm good on that.
803-404-6100, how you can weigh in. We'll get into some more of that, but up next, Preston Thorne. has got to tell us how the weekend was. It was an Easter weekend. There was a ton of sports. Major League Baseball was in full effect.
Oh, boy. Yeah.
Look forward to all of this. Thorns, Buds, and Roses comes up next. You're listening to The Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5 The Game in Columbia. 100.5 The Game in Florence. 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5 The Game app and streaming live on The Game TV. Download the 107.5 The Game app and listen anywhere. The beach. The gym. And yes, even there. Go to iTunes or Google Play and snag the 107.5 The Game app. 107.5 The Game. Broadcasting live from the Herndon Chevrolet Studios.
Discover Herndon Certified. Herndon Chevrolet's premier used car warranty. Shop with complete confidence knowing Herndon Chevrolet has got you covered.
Stop by or shop online today and see why Herndon Chevrolet makes you smile.
Bill Gunner for Old Timey Meat Market. It is grilling season, and I hope you're ready. I hope you got all your sauces, your spices, your rubs. And if you don't, that's just another great thing you can pick up at Old Timey Meat Market, along with incredible cuts of beef, pork, poultry. You get some great salmon there. Maybe you want a nice box, a 5-pound box of chicken breast to take home. And that we've always got something. Maybe a 5-pound box of ribeye steaks. Old Timey Meat Market has built their business on the idea of providing Columbia, Lexington, Irmo, South Congaree, and the surrounding areas with a non-grocery store meat buying experience. They want to meet you. They want to know your name. They want to provide you with the best variety and grades of meat available. That's why I go to Old Timey Meat Market when it's time for the Gunners to grill out, because they know my name. They know what I like. So go visit one of the three locations, St. Andrews and Irmo, South Congaree, or the Lexington store. Stop by Old Timey Meat Market. Tell them Bill Gunner sent you.
The Nest.
Hey, my name is Danny Johnson with RDJ Remodeling. Recently, I got a custom job of a lifetime. This project was going to demand a group of professionals who I could count on to understand the speed of business and get us answers in a timely manner. Rachel at The Nest and all of her coworkers, including the guys at the warehouse, have gone out of their way to be helpful. Their pricing has been in line with our expectations. Found a business I can count on. The Nest has truly been great to work with. Thank you, guys.
Come see for yourself at The Nest, 1331 Gadsden Street in the Vista.
Did you know that feeling sluggish or weighed down could be a sign that your digestive system isn't working at its best? Taking Metamucil every day can help. Metamucil fiber powders help promote your daily digestive health using a plant-based fiber called psyllium. The gelling action of this special fiber traps and removes waste so you can feel lighter and more energetic. Metamucil, promoting digestive health for a better you. Learn more at Metamucil.com. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. These products are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Life insurance. Why are you putting it off? Can't afford it? Too much hassle? Think you don't need it? There's lots of excuses for putting off life insurance. But if you weren't there, who would pay the mortgage and other bills? With Ethos, you could be covered in 10 minutes and boom, family protected. Ethos, fast and easy online term life insurance. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as $1 a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at getethos.com. That's getethos.com.
This is Monster Jam. Witness big air, two-wheel skills, backflips, and all-out racing. It's the only place to see the world's best riders tear up the dirt in your favorite Monster Jam trucks, like Grave Digger, El Toro Loco, Megalodon, and more. It's big-time fun for the whole family. Monster Jam, as big as it gets. Coming to Colonial Life Arena this weekend. Brought to you by BKT Tires, Great Clips, and Texas Roadhouse. Visit MonsterJam.com today.
Hello, my name is Joe Wilson, Member of Congress. I'm honored to serve the people of the 2nd District of South Carolina and want to make sure you know that our office is here to help you. Red tape can be overwhelming, so if you need assistance with veterans benefits, Social Security, Medicare, or other issues, please contact the office at area code 803-939-0041 or the website joewilson.house.gov. We are here to help you. Paid for by official funds authorized by the House of Representatives.
Attention business owners. Tired of parking headaches in your business lot? Get a fresh start with Schroeder's Towing. Call Schroeder's Towing and receive free custom signage, high-quality, eye-catching deterrence for unwanted parking. Call Schroeder's Towing, your partner for a stress-free, clear lot in 2024. They have over 1,300 reviews and a near 5-star rating backing up their work. Because this year, it's all about a fresh start and a clear lot with Schroeder's Towing.
Schroeder's Towing, the best and fastest hookers in town.
WIST-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
Clemson Road at Faro, still working that earlier tie-up, as well as Hardscrabble Road at Elders Pond Road. Traffic lights malfunctioning right there at Broad River Road, I-20 and Broad River Road, east and westbound. So just be aware of that. And other than that, things are moving along fairly nicely for your Monday morning. So we welcome that. And 84 will be our high today, breezy and warm, 85 tomorrow. And come Wednesday, could see some storms early, 74 for the high. We definitely enjoy 64 being the way we start the morning on the early game.
With Bill Gunter, Preston Thorne, and Jen Jensen.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia. 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
.403-404-6100, how you can weigh in. We'll get to Thorns, Buds, and Roses coming up here in just a second. A weekend that was, from Preston Thorne's perspective. But first, I want to remind you about the 107.5 The Game annual spring golf tournament. There is still time to register, and you need to get registered today. 803-755-2000 is how you can register. It'll be this Friday, April the 5th, at Charwood Golf Club. 10 a.m. shotgun start. $400 for a foursome. If you got two of you, we'll try and pair you up. It's $200 a pair. You can do the math on that. It's $100 per person. We'll have some South Carolina baseball tickets, Carowinds tickets, concert tickets, craft beer passports. We'll have those for raffles. We'll have a great breakfast from Old Timey Meat Market with onion sausage being provided. We'll also have some great lunch with Firehouse Subs providing box lunches, and of course a mimosa bar in the morning courtesy of Saki's Wine and Spirits. So get registered for a fun day of golf and some sports discussion with everyone involved. 803-755-2000 is how you can call Charwood today and get registered. We encourage you to do it. We're up over 20 teams right now, so it's going to be a good crowd, and we hope to see you out there. Preston and I will be broadcasting bright and early on Friday morning, so you can come on out and hang with us. Preston will hit the ceremonial opening tee shot to make you feel good about yourself. That's his goal. And we'll get the whole thing going again around 10 a.m. with the shotgun start. Hope to see you. Get registered today. Call Charwood 803-755-2000. Plenty for you to discuss this week, right? Not lacking.
A lot was happening.
Let's find out how it went. Here's Thorns, Buds, and Roses.
All right, Bill. Thorns, Buds, and Roses. Big week. Big week. Easter weekend, Resurrection Sunday. Big time for everybody who celebrates. And this is not my official thorn, but I have to get this out of the way because it irked me.
Okay.
We're getting soft.
No problem.
Easter egg hunts are no longer hunts. I've seen several occasions where they just put the Easter eggs out and the kids just go get the Easter eggs.
Oh, no, 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 no.
I've seen several occasions. I don't know what's happened. I don't know if this is a phenomenon that's spreading, but we have to stop this. I saw a very, just Easter eggs placed. They didn't have to scrounge for them. All I'm saying is we need to watch where we're going with this. Slippery slope.
I mean, if there may be a toddler, I get it. Mm-mm. They don't quite understand.
I'm just telling you.
Yeah.
What I'm saying, I'm just warning
but
you.
But beyond that, no, I agree. I think
just warning you. All right. Official thorn. Check his birth certificate. DJ Burns, sir. Zion Williamson.
Yep.
Aaron Naismith.
Yeah.
These guys are NBA pros for years.
Mm-hmm.
You, sir, were in the same recruiting class as them. How long you been around? Also, Bill, remember the freshies? Remember when they came to the University of South Carolina, broke all the records,
yeah,
won championships? They're gone. They've come and went, and they came in 2019. That was the year after DJ Burns was supposed to go to college. DJ Burns, sir, you put me in a really tough situation because I don't like all of these grown men playing college sports at 24, 25. However, for my bud, you know what B stands for, Bill?
Big boy.
Biggins.
Biggins.
Good job. Biggins. You, sir, I hope there are plenty of little Biggins out there that just watching DJ Burns and they inspired. Because once long ago, there was a Biggin that played basketball in Somerville, South Carolina. And he didn't know if he was going to get the vertical. He wasn't going to be 6'8", but he had the 275 covered. And he wanted to play basketball, too. But you know what they told me in Somerville? I mean, you know what they told that kid in Somerville?
Oh, you were at the home. You were a varsity blues situation there. There's no doubt they looked at you instantly and was like, nah, buddy. Come right on here. Here's some football pads.
I wanted to hoop, too. But they told me, no, son, you're going to play nose guard. So listen, all you Biggins out there that have hoop dreams, watch our new king, DJ Burns, the Biggin King. Watch him. Enjoy him. You rarely get to see a big man move with such fluidity, jumping 3 inches off the ground, throwing hooks over his left shoulder. It's a sight to see. For all of my Biggins out there, either relive the moments that you thought you could have had, or if you see a little boy that's shopping in the Husky section, tell him too. You too can be DJ Burns. And fourth, roses. We need four roses. I think this one is pretty clear.
Oh. Final four.
Final four. Final four, 4 years in a row, four different teams, 6 out of 10 seasons. Different styles, different players. It doesn't matter, except for what Dawn says, and in honor of April Fool's Day, these are not going to be regular roses. These are going to be trick roses. And when we give them to Dawn, water's going to squirt out of them.
Because she's
silly team. You know, there's a lot of jokes.
Maybe you should have gone for she gets the rose lapel.
Lapel rose.
Smell just, it.
Yep, little squirt gun out of that. So congratulations to Dawn. I would like to say, and I think this is going to be controversial, but I think the mission is accomplished. Final four, I know championships are the expectations, but once you get to the final four, I think you can officially say that you've had a great season. So four roses for the final four squad, and let's go and see if we can finish out. Put the cherry on top of what already is a great season.
That is a wild take. Because it is correct, but I still don't know if I agree with it. Yeah. There is no denying it's a great season.
Yep.
There is no denying whatsoever it is a great season. It's an incredible season. They're undefeated. They've done it with a team that everybody has brand new stars and everything. It's an incredible season.
And there are so many games. They've dominated in a lot of games, but there have been, especially in this tournament, there have been nail biters, which is fantastic, mm-hmm. You know, for viewership and all of that.
Yep.
But yeah, so it's like, imagine next year.
That's where we are. We're already starting to go there.
Well, can you have a great season and it not be successful?
Yeah.
We had some of this conversation last year.
A great season, it'd be a failure. Because I just look at it, you know, and you have these opportunities. And they don't come around all the time.
Contrary to
what is happening is not the norm.
Right.
What is happening is not the norm.
And it will not last forever.
Right. And you have to take advantage when the windows open. And they missed one last year. They missed one.
Mm-hmm.
And unfortunately, not through no fault of their own. Absolutely zero fault of their own.
Yeah, because
they missed one in the COVID year.
That's also it. But also last year, guess who they lost to? The eventual women's scoring leader, right?
Right.
So even if you weren't aware, you were like, who is this? Who did they lose to? Well, they lost to the best last year. And so, yes.
They lost to the best player.
Best player last year.
Not in my opinion, the best team, but they did lose to the best player. And, you know, for all these accolades, again, through no fault of South Carolina's own, they didn't get to play for the 2020 National Championship, one that we think that they would have won. That'd give Dawn three.
They were on pace.
Aaliyah had the missed tip-in 2021.
Final four.
Last year, you lose to Iowa. I don't know. And this is not a put-down of the team because it's unfair to Dawn, but it is fair to discuss that two is incredible. Two is phenomenal. Should they have three now? Should they have four? If you don't win this one and you're still sitting on two, do you look back and go, whoa, what could have been?
I think that's a very fair assessment. When you start looking at dynasties, when you think about when teams get into dynasty mode, you will look back and say maybe they actually could have got one more or they actually should have got two more. The reason why I say this season, I do think last year, though it was an amazing season, it was an awesome season, I don't think they accomplished the mission last year because it was the freshies and it was the seniors and it was championship or bust last year. This team has exceeded expectations, and I think they've gotten to this point. Now, we obviously still want to win a championship, and I still think that's very much within their grasp, but they can say this season has been an extreme success to this point. But there is a little bit more. Their goals are still in front of them, as we like to say.
And I'll say this, and thank you to Dawn Staley for allowing us to have this conversation. It is fun to try and discuss what true greatness is, because no offense to anybody else that's ever coached the soccer team. Ray Tanner was the closest with what he was doing. These are wild conversations to have when we're debating just how great being great is. Like, where is that line in there? Because of you're so good, we're wondering if you have not won enough championships to be there. That is an incredible feat to accomplish. And Dawn Staley has us having that conversation, which is insane. Of we know how great you're, but it's not too that they're just going, say, just random 26-4 and lose. I mean, these are dominant teams. It's almost going back to it's to an extent, you don't win this one. I almost start to look at you kind of like we looked at the Braves in the 90s.
Now you're getting deep into my 12-year-old soul here, and that's a tough one. And I think it's fair. I do think there's some questions in that.
We'll continue on with that. We'll start to move toward wrapping up the program. We've got about another 30 minutes left. I will say I might join you next week with either a rose, a bud, or a thorn. I'll tell you about that when I come back, because I'm going to start an experiment today, a 7-day free trial. It'll be a quick little thing on what.
So what you're saying is you don't know whether it's going to be.
I'm going to tell you on what has been a thorn, and I'm going to make a slight adjustment today. I'm going to take a 7-day free trial starting today.
Okay.
And I'll keep you updated on this because I've seen this over the weekend. 803-404-6100. You're listening to The Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5 The Game in Columbia. 100.5 The Game in Florence. 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5 The Game app. And streaming live on The Game TV.
Listen to Gamecocks baseball on The Game. And if a Gamecocks batter hits a grand slam,
you could win cash. You could win cash.
You could win cash.
You could win cash in the Palmetto Citizens Federal Credit Union Grand Slam Giveaway. Go to 1075thegame.com and register. Brought to you by Palmetto Citizens Federal Credit Union and The Game.
Bill Gunner for AAA Heating and Air. Now is the time of the season that you need to start thinking about your air conditioner during the summer. Get out ahead of the Midlands heat. Go ahead and get comfort in your house tomorrow with a phone call today. 803-677-1500. You can contact AAA Heating and Air and speak with a technician and get a free a free replacement estimate today to find out what you'd have to pay. And in this year, in 2024, you can pay no interest and not a dime until 2025. There's no better time to contact AAA Heating and Air than today to get comfort in your home tomorrow. And also, don't forget, AAA Heating and Air now providing professional and residential electrical services, including electrical panel upgrades, lighting installation and repair, and new generator installations. Call AAA Heating and Air today, 803-677-1500. Tell them Bill Gunner sent you.
The tournament is here. Bet Online is your bracket headquarters for this season with the best bracket contest out there and odds, lines, and info on every game and every round right up until the national championship. Head to Bet Online today to stay updated on all the action. Bet Online, the game starts here.
Hi, everybody. This is Woody Windham here to talk about Pioneer Tree Service. Pioneer Tree Service has more than four decades of helping homeowners maintain and manage trees on their property. Their skilled crew offers customized solutions that match your needs and budget. Tree trimming and tree removal can be dangerous. You need to trust the people that are doing the job. Before attempting to remove limbs, call Pioneer Tree Service for a free quote. They remove limbs safely and make sure that future growth is directed away from potential trouble areas such as roof lines and driveways. Cutting down trees takes more than a chainsaw. Even branches can weigh thousands of pounds, and their removal must be handled with care. Pioneer Tree Service offers a full complement of state-of-the-art heavy equipment, from track hoes to bucket trucks to safely remove trees and stumps from your property. And no matter where you live, the Gantt girls can get there. And I want you to call them at 803-794-8253.
Hey there, Columbia. All of us at Village Idiot Pizza would like to congratulate Dawn Staley, Lamont Paris, and both their teams on a phenomenal regular season, and thank you for the memories. Speaking of making memories, come make some with us at either Village Idiot location, Five Points or Olympia at the Mills. Together, all postseason long, let's cheer on our Gamecocks. You may call it one thing, but we call it the third month of the calendar craziness.
You already know that Palmetto Citizens Federal Credit Union offers truly free checking and great rates on auto loans, but did you know they do mortgages too? Whether you need a first or second mortgage, a home equity line of credit, or a loan for construction, renovation, a lot, or a manufactured home, Palmetto Citizens has you covered. They're a community financial institution based solely here in the Midlands, so they offer a refreshingly simple mortgage process you won't get from the big banks or online lenders. Along with a great rate, the Palmetto Citizens mortgage team will work with you to tailor the loan to best fit your needs and budget. Apply for your mortgage today by visiting palmettocitizens.org or stopping by any of their 14 branches across the Midlands. Palmetto Citizens, proudly serving this community since 1936. Equal Housing Lender, NMLS ID number 449962. Approval based on credit worthiness. Certain restrictions may apply.
What you're talking about.
Brought to you by Love Chevy. Act now for Springtacular Savings on the best selection of new Chevys. I-26 at Harbison and at lovechevy.com. Together, let's drive. Hit us up on the Firehouse Subs text line, 803-404-6100.
Your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game. Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
WIST-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia, wetzelsauto.com.
I-20 eastbound at exit 58, that would be Highway 1. There is an accident right there on the ramp, so caution if you are having to exit off right there at I-20 eastbound at Highway 1. Also, still traffic light malfunctioning, I-20 eastbound and westbound right there at Broad River Road. And Hardscrabble Road at Elders Pond Road, still working that earlier tie-up. Pretty nice for today and tomorrow. 84, breezy and warm today, 85 tomorrow. Might see some showers rolling in early on Wednesday and a high of 74. But loving this mornings where we're not in the 40s or anything. Right now it is 64 on the early game.
Talking about, sponsored by Love Chevrolet,
on your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
Preston saying, make the Easter egg hunting more difficult. You gotta, don't just put the eggs out in the yard. Hide them in the bushes. Hide them in the trees.
Just make them work for it a little bit.
Jim weighing in and says, I promise you, this is true. Mom and Dad would put out hard-boiled eggs for us to find, and it would be sometimes a week or two later when we were mowing the lawn, we would find one of those hard-boiled eggs.
Yeah, that's the spirit. That's the spirit. That's what I'm talking about.
Or the, like, dogs find them.
Yeah, somebody finds it. He's like, well, I just didn't find it.
Worst thing is the dog finds it, right?
Yeah.
That's a problem. That's an issue.
Especially if it's not a hard-boiled egg and it's, you know, something that candy or something that's wrapped. And, yeah, if you find that in many ways.
Yeah, not good. Lamont weighs in and sends this picture. He says, Preston, got one coming for you. It's a picture of a young man playing some basketball. And, Preston?
He put him on the radar service. I'm going to start a scouting service. Biggins. Any Biggins out there that's playing basketball, are you a child who may not be able to make the weight limit for your football team? They don't have weight limits in basketball, and that's great. So let's bring him onto the basketball court, and you two can be like DJ Burns. This kid right here, he already has a T-shirt underneath his jersey.
Yep.
I like his style.
There you go. Yeah, there you go. 803-404-6100. Over the weekend, Major League Baseball got underway. And I was trying on Thursday, we'll have our Chop Talk segment coming up at 7 a.m. We'll get you all the updates on the Braves and update them. They go 2-1 this weekend, lose to the Phillies 5-4 yesterday. They'll be in Chicago for a series with the White Sox starting today. It'll be an early game, by the way, for the Braves. 2:10 today as they get going in Chicago. Good start, by the way. Very good start for the Braves. Charlie Morton on the mound today. So,
who's 40 years old, by the way?
Is he 40 now?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, he is. He'll be 41 in November. That's a good point. Hanging around. All right. So we'll be in one of the categories next week, Preston, because it's been a thorn, and last Thursday I was upset. I would have been more upset over the weekend, but we had an AAU basketball tournament down in Augusta, and then yesterday was Easter, and I was into the Final Four. I was into the women's game. I was into a lot of it. I watched the race last night, which, Jen, we've made it 2.5 hours, 2 hours and 38 minutes without me mentioning the race last night and who won the race, which was Denny Hamlin, which I was thrilled about. And I had Denny Hamlin, which I was thrilled about, and I've made it 2 hours and 40 minutes without mentioning that. I should get some kind of prize today. But I was into other things really this weekend than Major League Baseball. But I had it in the background. I would have been disgusted with Major League Baseball if, because of their baseball TV package, Preston. I am so unhappy. So, again, so what I'm going to do today, and by the way, if you have an opinion on this, I am interested to weigh in and let Preston and I know. I have YouTube TV. And I tell you that because YouTube TV, number one, doesn't have Bally Sports for the Braves. Two, doesn't have the MLB Network. I am extremely limited on the amount of Major League Baseball I can watch, and I think this is the year that I want to make an effort to watch more. I think I'm hitting that age where a lemonade and sitting outside and watching a baseball game is the thing that I've got to start to do to relax in life. I'll be 42 in about a month. I'm going to do the 7-day free trial of the MLB Network package, whatever that is. Because I really can't figure out if it's the MLB Network, whatever. I've got it.
You got to get the VPN to do it.
To see the Braves. All right. I don't know how to do that, and it sounds like we're going to break some laws off air now for you to instantly know exactly what I'm talking about, and I appreciate that you're here now for me on that. But, Preston, I'll show you this. Like, it's the MLB.TV. I'm going to buy this package. I'm going to do the free trial for 7 days. Next Monday, I'll be able to tell you whether this is thorn, bud, or rose. I'm interested to hear people's opinion on this that want to watch baseball, because as Jen just pointed out, and Jen, you're able to see the Cubs regardless, all 162 games, home and away, if you were to purchase that. It's Braves fans like me who have YouTube TV who do not get Bally Sports.
Because you're blacked out.
That were blacked out. I'll only be able to see the away games.
Yeah, and we just went through this with my son, and that's what we're having to do, is the MLB and the VPN, and use that combination to make it work.
I'm not sure how legal this is to discuss on radio like this. I don't know. I have no idea. I really don't. I don't know if that's...
I think it's just you're buying services, you know?
I'll be interested to hear at least
off-air. It's got to be easier than this. It has to be easier.
For Major League Baseball, this is ridiculous.
It is ridiculous that you're having to figure out how to piecemeal things together to be able to watch. Yeah.
Yeah, when the thing, and as I've said before, the reason why I became a Braves fan was because it was on all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And the best way to enjoy baseball season is just to drop in, drop out, let it be playing in the background, catch a game here, catch a game there. It's sort of something that you just, it's a slow burn throughout the year. That's why baseball works for you mm-hmm. throughout the summer. And so it doesn't really work when you can just watch one game here or there. You kind of have to just follow right. along and see what's going on throughout the year. And if it, to your point, if it's very difficult or it's cumbersome or I have to go through so many steps to get there, me personally, I'm not going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. it's like, even if it's just three extra clicks, I'm just like, I'm not, it's too much. Or if there's another password involved.
Right.
I'm out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this password.
And literally, if you're having to search for an hour to figure out
that's tough.
What the solution is, that's ridiculous. And when they're having trouble getting eyes on baseball games to start with, you better make it a little more accessible.
Yeah, I because it's the league. I bought the league pass for the NBA, and I watched a little bit of the Heat and the Wizards last night. Midsummer, we'll play a game of what did you watch last night, and it could end up being like
that's called getting your money's worth.
Yeah.
That's we bought all of this. We're gonna eat it.
Yeah, so, yeah, it's the leftovers of Easter yesterday. The Heat fan in me. It's the problem.
That's your pass. I'll give you a pass on that.
The problem has been when I've gotten into Pistons games recently that I'm just sitting there watching. I am interested to know this because, again, I do kind of want to get into baseball more. And like you said, I don't think we realized how good we had it until it's gone when baseball was on, when 7:05 every night or 10:05 when they were on the West Coast, you were catching the Braves on TBS.
Well, that was my thing. I would do the 7:05 or the 10:05, and then I would do the Cubs earlier in the day.
Yep.
Maybe playing the day game, and then you just watch a little bit of baseball, and you get familiar with the league by watching all of these teams come through and play your team. And now you know things that are happening throughout the league.
And it's just crazy. So I am interested if you have MLB, the league pass or whatever they're exactly calling. I think I've got it here on my phone. As I look at MLB.tv, it looks like what I have to purchase, $29.99 a month or $149.99 for the year. I'm going to do the 7-day trial and then make the decision. And that will be potentially a thorn bud or rose for me next week. 803-404-6100. Nothing to do with that discussion, but Monty weighs in and says, I had a yellow lab that ate 23 hard-boiled Easter eggs, shells and all. One time. Ooh.
Respect.
Ooh. And he says, and the best basketball biggin is Snacks.
Snacks was a baller. Snacks was a baller. Absolutely.
803-404-6100. We'll come back. We'll wrap it up this morning. You're listening to Preston Norton, Bill Gunner. She's Jen Jensen. It's the Early Game.
The Game Network.
The home of the Gamecocks. 107.5, The Game in Columbia. 100.5, The Game in Florence. 100.3, The Game in Myrtle Beach.
Also on the 107.5, The Game app. And streaming live on The Game TV. Powered by Integrated Media, The Game TV.
Sponsored by Shepherd's Glass, a true reflection of quality.
The Game TV.
This is Boomer and Science with the CBS Sports Minute. Today's birthday shout-out goes to Mitchell Robinson. The Knicks' 26-year-old 7-foot center had been out of commission with an ankle injury since December 8th. Last week, he finally returned to the lineup, only to re-injure the ankle. Having the Loch Ness Monster back, albeit with rusty timing, will help Tom Thibodeau for what yours truly hopes will be a deep playoff run. I'm Boomer and Science.
Check engine light on? Take the guesswork out of your check engine light with O'Reilly Veriscan. It's free. Ask for O'Reilly Veriscan today.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
DQ presents the sound of BOGO free Blizzard treats in the DQ app. It's the sound of downloading the DQ app, redeeming the sweetest BOGO free Blizzard deal, telling all your friends, and heading to DQ for BOGO free any size Blizzard treats only in the DQ app for a limited time. Download it today. At participating locations, limitations apply. DQ. Happy tastes good.
Power through your spring at Lowe's with Ego, the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power. Buy one select string trimmer, leaf blower, or mower kit. Get one select 56-volt battery free. Valid through 4-3 while supplies last. Selection varies by location.
Bill Gunner for Mid-State Roofing. Summer thunderstorms are on their way. You know it's coming here in the Midlands. And is your roof ready to handle it? It better be. If not, you might want to just go ahead and call Mid-State Roofing today. Get them out to your house. Get a little maintenance contract lined up and make sure everything is in working order. And at Mid-State Roofing, they have a 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week call center. You can speak with someone, even if you have an issue in the middle of the night. And that goes for Florence, Myrtle Beach, or wherever you may be listening this morning on your 107.5 The Game app. Mid-State Roofing is there to protect that roof. That's why they've been the leader for nearly 30 years, the proven leader in the roofing and waterproofing industry, and they want to make sure your roof is ready to handle these summer thunderstorms. So call today, 803-356-1919. Again, that's 803-356-1919. You'll speak with an on-call technician, and they'll be ready to help you. If you've got a leak, let Mid-State Roofing take a peek.
There's something remarkable about the University of South Carolina. It's in the labs, where researchers are discovering ways to make communities healthier and stronger. It's in the nation's best first-year student experience, in top-ranked programs in nursing and health sciences. It's where more South Carolina students have access to higher education than ever before. Because when you stand for something bigger than yourself, you can create something that benefits us all. Behold, the remarkable we.
Hi, yes, I'll have the club sandwich and house salad.
You got it, sweetie. I'll throw in a pair of designer sunglasses as well.
Just lunch, thanks.
How about a week at my boss's oceanfront villa?
What?
When you join the South Carolina Education Lottery's Players Club, you get way more than you expect. More chances, more wins, and more surprises.
Today's special, a trip to low Earth orbit in a private spaceship.
Join the Players Club at seeducationlottery.com because more happens here.
The Early Game with Bill Gunter,
former Gamecock Preston Thorne,
and Jen Jensen, your home of the Gamecocks in Columbia, 107.5 The Game.
Also heard on 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach and 100.5 The Game in Florence.
As we wrap it up here on your Monday morning, reminder, you can always listen to us if you're traveling. Obviously, right here in Columbia, 107.5 The Game, 100.5 The Game in Florence, 100.3 The Game in the Grand Strand on Myrtle Beach. You can catch us down there. If you haven't already, please make sure you tell your friends, especially those ones in Florence and Myrtle Beach. Get the word out. We are on down in Florence and Myrtle Beach. Again, 100.5 The Game in Florence, 100.3 The Game in Myrtle Beach. As always, if you leave either Columbia, Florence, or Myrtle Beach, you can take us anywhere. 107.5 The Game app. Just go to your app store. We've had people listening from South Africa, from Germany. We had Las Vegas recently, from Hawaii. So you've had all kinds of places tuning in and texting in and joining us. And, of course, you can stream us on the Game TV on YouTube. Go to the Game TV Radio, and that is sponsored by Shepherd's Glass. Just another way for you to be able to join in each and every morning as we wrap it up, Preston, on a weekend, an Easter weekend that was a huge sporting weekend. As I just said, I had Major League Baseball on in the background, but I was really intrigued by what was happening with South Carolina baseball, and of course the Final Four, both are the Elite Eight, Sweet 16, Elite Eight of both sides.
Yeah, big, huge weekend. Again, I watched the game on Friday night, watched the women play, and people were super excited about that. The games all weekend. A lot happening. Also, man, awesome. You know, Twitter's a cesspool, but very similar to Christmas, Resurrection Sunday, Easter. You get to see people's families. It feels a little lighter. It's like this is very nice. You see people being happy. So it was a good day to be perusing the interwebs.
It was a beautiful day yesterday, 80 degrees, and as you just mentioned, I think there was something to do with the fact that it was March 31st, and today opens a whole new month where we're going to hopefully get rid of the pollen within the next week and a half, two weeks.
That would be nice.
Weather's going to change. Got the Masters coming up here in 2 weeks, the Heritage in 3 weeks, the spring football game for South Carolina, the Garnet and Black game, which Preston, I understand. Preston went out of his way to schedule, from what I understand, a trip to D.C. with the not his child, but the kids that he has to avoid the cocky trot run that he lost.
Whatever works.
For, I don't even remember what the wager was now.
It was for the Lexington Somerville
game. That's right. Yeah. So we have to find something in May that Preston has to make that. Maybe we might just strap one of our devices to him, our things, and make him run or walk, because it's not like you would run anyway. Walk one morning doing the show. I had to do this one time, walk to campus and walk around campus and back.
That might not be a bad. I can handle that.
We might do that, figure out what 5K is for that. One other thing from the weekend. Have you seen this? I don't know how this keeps happening, but this was, you mentioned social media, and this was what brought this up. Did you see yesterday the social media clip of a March 2015 episode of The Simpsons?
I have.
That apparently called yesterday's action again?
Yes. Listen, man, this happens all the time with The Simpsons. I don't know if it's because they just made 30 seasons of a show where they're bound to get some things right, but it is eerie sometimes how correct they are on their future predictions. Like, this one had the date. Is it March 31st? 31st. What in the world? How does that happen?
March 31st. There was an episode that had March 31st, and Marge is complimenting Homer on a sober March. Didn't get in trouble at St. Patrick's Day. No bad behavior through the NCAA basketball tournament, and it flips over to Homer, and he's holding up a Duke. I think he's holding up an NC State.
Like a pennant.
Pennant, and wearing a Duke shirt.
Yeah.
And wearing a St. Patrick's hat. And it says March 31st.
Yeah, listen, that's crazy.
It happens very more often than you think. But again, I don't know. They made 30 seasons of the show.
Still making it. I mean.
Yeah, still happening. Which is weird, by the way. So I guess they're bound to get some things right sometimes, but it is sort of.
She said something in there about Easter too. She basically, you can look through the calendar through the years and figure out what Easter is going to be. But yeah, basically she makes a comment about Easter. It was a great Easter for you and Homer, and that was another thing circulating yesterday on the internet.
Yeah.
Tonight,
big one.
This is wild to me that and I don't know how many others care. I think we care in this market because of what Dawn has done. Again, this is a testament to Dawn growing the game and now growing it outside of South Carolina to where we actually, there will be, whether you watch all 40 minutes or whether you have it on in the background, whatever, Iowa and LSU will draw eyes tonight. It's going to be a massive television ratings win for ESPN.
Yeah, for sure. People are going to be drawn in. And then when you get the casuals coming in, obviously they may not know what to expect, so you'll see a lot of chatter. But it'll be a great game because both of these teams are here. Shout out to the NCAA for making these brackets, for things happening. Bill, you're getting your wish because there was a couple chances along the way that the Cinderellas were going to knock this out. But this is what you want. You want to see the marquee names in the marquee games. And so not only at the 7 o'clock, but then at the 9 o'clock, you have Juju Watkins and Paige Beckers going at it with USC. So a great night for women's basketball total at 7 and 9 o'clock today.
All in all, I'm going to be very content with the Final Fours moving forward. I'm okay. NC State was a 3 seed. South Carolina, NC State, that'll be a good matchup in the women's side. Whatever you get, Connecticut and Iowa, you know, Southern Cal and LSU. Let me just say this. I think we might be trending toward a Southern Cal, South Carolina national championship game.
I like it.
Somebody put that in earlier. Fun show.
Great show.
Be back tomorrow. We will do it all over again. Y'all have a great day.
Broadcasting live from the Herndon Chevrolet Studios, this is 107.5 The Game.
A great selection of new Chevys is available now at Herndon Chevrolet. The lot is packed with inventory and more is on the way. So shop your hometown Chevy dealer today.
Stop by or shop online today and see why Herndon Chevrolet makes you smile.
Now all lottery purchases come with more chances to win cash, merchandise, and other great prizes with the launch of Players Club Rewards. Scan your winning or non-winning tickets in the SC Lottery app and start winning more. See SCEducationLottery.com for more information.
Palmetto Citizens Federal Credit Union wants to reward you for saving more of your hard-earned money, and they can't think of a better way to do it than with more cash. When you participate in Palmetto Citizens Save to Win program, every time you make a savings deposit of just $25, you'll be entered into a monthly and quarterly prize drawing for a chance to win up to $5,000. All the money that piles up in your Save to Win account is yours to keep, along with the interest you earned, so there's never been a better time to get the ball rolling on your savings plan. With a Save to Win account, there's nothing to lose and everything to win. Open your 12-month Save to Win term certificate account and start saving today by visiting any of Palmetto Citizens' 14 branches across the Midlands, or go to palmettocitizens.org to learn more. Palmetto Citizens, proudly serving the Midlands since 1936. Account may be subject to penalty for early withdrawal. This credit union is federally insured by the NCUA.
She is the track too tough to take.
The Lady in Black. She's got a thing for tradition, a hankering for history, and she sure likes a good challenge. Well, when Throwback Weekend comes to town, she'll get exactly what she wants and play extra hard to get.
These guys are going to have their hands full.
Shall We Dance? The official Throwback Weekend of NASCAR, May 10th through the 12th. Get your tickets now at darlingtonraceway.com.
Join the Lexington Medical Center Foundation on Saturday, April 20th at the Pastides Alumni Center for the McDaniels Golf Classic Gala. Featuring live and silent auctions, Capital City catering, and live music by the Crystal Clear Band. Proceeds benefit the McDaniels Pucci Cancer Fund and support programs and services at Lexington Medical Cancer Center, from diagnosis to survivorship. Purchase your tickets today at McDanielsGolfClassic.com.
Coming up April 5th, you don't want to miss another golf tournament with 107.5 The Game. That's right, it's the Spring Golf Tournament at Charwood Golf Club. Call today and reserve your team's spot. $400 per team. We'll have breakfast, we'll have lunch, and we'll have all your favorite celebrities from 107.5 The Game. So come on out to Charwood Golf Club. April 5th, that's a Friday, 10 a.m. tee time. Call today, 803-755-2000. That's calling Charwood, and reserve your spot today.
The Amazon's rainforest is being cut down so fast that by 2030, 55% of it could be completely wiped out. The Earth's forests can't speak up when they need help, but we can. Be the voice for those who have no voice. Visit worldwildlife.org.
WIST-TV First Alert Traffic is sponsored by Wetzel's Automotive in West Columbia. Wetzelsauto.com.
Had a wreck on the exit ramp of I-20 eastbound at Highway 1, exit 58, Lexington. Also, I-20 east and west at Broad River Road. Well, it is, really, it's going to be Broad River Road. It says traffic lights are not working there, so that's a problem. Also, we got a wreck reported at Hardscrabble Road at Elders Pond. The weather outlook for today, 84 for a high, breezy, warm, 0% chance of rain today, but tomorrow that's going to change. Going to be mostly cloudy, 80% chance of rain, 85 for a high, 66 for a low. Wednesday, 74, early storms on Wednesday. Then it'll turn sunny again for Thursday and Friday.
WKTFM, Eastover Columbia.
This is Gamecock Athletics Director Ray Tanner, and you're listening to 107.5 The Game,
a Cumulus Media station. The extra point, the extra point, the extra point, the extra point.
With Tyler Head and Gamecock Central on your home.
Florence. 9 o'clock on your Monday morning. Welcome in. It is the Extra Point. Tyler Head along with you. Happy April 1st, otherwise known as April Fool's Day, to everyone out there. Don't believe most of the things that you read or see today, because they might not be true. I've already been I haven't been fooled by anything today. I've just scrolling through Twitter a little bit earlier, I saw some things like, wow, that's cool. Oh, wait a minute. It's April 1st. I know Florida Atlantic's football Twitter account tweeted out that they were playing South Florida on an aircraft carrier, which I've been an advocate for football on an aircraft carrier for a long time. We can do basketball. Why can't we try football, right? But they tweeted that out earlier, and I was like, oh, that's neat. Then I was like, oh, yeah, it's April 1st. That's actually not going to happen today. So be skeptical of everything that you see or read today. Don't get yourself in trouble because of an April Fool's joke. Busy weekend, fun weekend. First of all, it was absolutely beautiful outside. Great weather on Saturday. I enjoyed meeting a lot of you out at the Carolina Cup out there in Camden. Was a very unique experience, I'll say that much, from a purely people-watching standpoint. Quite a few stories coming away from that on Saturday up there in Camden. But, again, had a great time. Enjoyed meeting a lot of you, and appreciate all you guys that came by and saw us at our booth out there in the infield. Hopefully had a good time, and hopefully avoided getting some sunburn like I did. Inevitably, the first, like, nice day of the year where I'm outside for a significant amount of time, and I was out there from 9 a.m. until almost 4 on Saturday. You don't think about sunscreen because you go through the entire winter not worrying about it. Then you're outside for a couple hours on a beautiful spring day, and then suddenly get burnt. So tips of my ears, nose, and, like, the back of my neck, a little bit crispy this morning. But otherwise, all good. And it was obviously a great weekend from a Gamecock sports standpoint, especially talking about the women, because once again, they have punched their ticket to a fourth straight Final Four after taking down Indiana and Oregon State in the Sweet 16 and the Elite Eight, respectively. It was not easy by any means. And I guess when you looked at the first two rounds of this NCAA tournament for South Carolina, with just steamrolling Presbyterian, which didn't really come as a surprise. That was a team that they had handled pretty easily back in the regular season, and then just rolling over North Carolina too. I think that's the one that maybe we all kind of looked at. I know I certainly looked at it and said, oh, this team's going to be, you know, a machine running through the rest of the tournament if they continue to play at this kind of level. And obviously that was a one game, and not always indicative of how the next game's going to go. I go back to Friday when we were out at Quaker Steak and Lube, which also was a really great time. Appreciate our guy Adam Vance and everyone at Sound and Images and everyone over there at Quaker Steak and Lube for setting us up out there. Had a really cool time. But Terry and I were talking about this game on Friday night, Friday afternoon, I guess, against Indiana. You know, it was a 15-point spread. And I was very confident that South Carolina was going to have another pretty dominant win once again. And it certainly looked like South Carolina was en route to doing that. You go to 7:30 left in the third quarter. South Carolina is up by 22 points at that point in time. And with how dominant this team's been for so long, we just have kind of have this preconceived notion in our mind that when they're up by a big margin, well, that margin is going to continue to grow and they're going to end up winning the game by 30 or 40 points. But we saw just a couple of weeks ago at the SEC tournament against Tennessee, that is not always the case, especially when you're playing a really, really good team. And guess what? Indiana making it all the way to the Sweet 16. Guess what? That means they're a pretty good team. And they were able to slowly chip away at South Carolina to prove that, hey, no matter how good South Carolina is, no lead is truly safe. One of the big keys going into that game on Friday afternoon was South Carolina limiting Indiana from the outside. We knew South Carolina had the paint unlocked. That is never a question. South Carolina, with the size that they have, with Cardoso being 6'7", like, that's never a question on who's most likely going to win the paint battle in these games. But Indiana was one of the rare teams that is really, really good from the outside that can pose enough of a threat to South Carolina. And South Carolina wasn't quite as effective enough in limiting them from the outside as they would have wanted to over the course of that entire game. They ended up going 13 of 33, so 40% from beyond the three-point line. And give credit where it's due to Sydney Paris, because she just could not miss in the second half. And suddenly you find yourself in a two-point game there, late against South Carolina. And give credit to Indiana's defense as well, because they were forcing South Carolina into some uncomfortable shots that helped them continue to dwindle that lead, because South Carolina was not making their shots while, Indiana was. But this is one of those situations where great players and great teams can step up when needed. South Carolina had not had a single three-pointer since Indiana started their comeback Ravens drained one after Indiana had cut that lead down to two to get it back out to five. And from there, South Carolina was able to manage the gap and pick up the win 79 to 75 to advance through to the Elite Eight. So that's, again, one of those games that, you know, I think we looked at going into it and thought South Carolina was going to be able to handle their business pretty easily. Obviously not the case. And I don't think you necessarily feared that South Carolina was going to lose that game. It just got uncomfortable. Because again, when you talk about having again another 20-plus point lead like you had against Tennessee, you don't expect these teams to come back. But again, that shows that South Carolina's not perfect, and nobody said that they were. And that was kind of one of those games that you look at and say, okay, well, that was a gutsy win. Now, how do you respond in your next game out? And as we saw against Tennessee earlier in the season in the SEC championship game, where South Carolina had to form their own comeback in that game, you know, they took on LSU in the next game in the SEC championship, and it was very much back and forth, but South Carolina never really lost control of that one necessarily. Obviously went on to win that one and, you know, win the SEC championship overall. So then you fast forward to yesterday, where you're taking on Oregon State, which by the way, give credit to Oregon State for, you know, getting past a very good Notre Dame team and their Sweet 16 matchup on Thursday to set up this matchup. And South Carolina was able to pick up the win 70-58, which was a little less dramatic, but not by you know, a whole lot, as they truly threw everything they could at you know, at South Carolina. And Carolina once again had their lead cut down to just 2 points there in the you know, there in the third quarter. And South Carolina proceeded to go on a 12-0 run after that to pull away. And that wasn't the only thing. That wasn't the only, you know, shot that Oregon State had at them in the second half, though, because they ended up pulling right back up to them and made it, you know, 58-62 with 4 minutes left in the game. But South Carolina was able to hold them to, you know, no makes from beyond the arc in the third quarter after allowing six in the first half, as they were another team coming into this game that we knew was going to be effective from the outside, which, again, when you go back to that game against Indiana, we knew could potentially spell problems for South Carolina. So, again, they were making seemingly all their shots in the first half. It seemed like South Carolina held them out in the third quarter to not making any. But then you had the combination of Hansford and Gardner making back-to-backs early on in the fourth quarter, and South Carolina proceeded to go 1-for-6 from the field over their next couple of possessions, then all of a sudden you're sweating again because you're in this really, really tight ball game. And similarly to what happened with Raven on Friday, where she sinks a Keith three-pointer after South Carolina had gone cold from three, where they were able to push the lead back out to five and be able to manage the gap a little bit from there in the waning minutes of that game against Indiana. You had another young player step up and make things happen in Sunday's game against Oregon State. This one happened to be Tessa Johnson, as she scored 7 of the final 8 points for South Carolina in the last couple of minutes of that game after Indiana had made it a tight ball game. And then the defense didn't allow any more points after that. Again, over the course of the final 4 minutes of the game for South Carolina to pull away and pick up that 70-58 victory. So, you know, would we have loved to have seen South Carolina go out there and steamroll two more teams? Absolutely. But obviously, you know, the deeper and deeper you get in these kind of tournaments, the tougher and tougher it's going to get. And, you know, these are I'd say, character-building type of wins, which is a weird thing to say when you're talking this late into the season, especially in a tournament type of setting. But, you know, these are the kind of things that you can build off of. And these are the kind of things that can, in a way, keep you grounded a little bit to show you that you're not unstoppable. And there were certainly times this season where it felt like South Carolina could not be touched by anyone. And again, as you've gotten into this postseason, you've played some real tough, grinded out type of games. And South Carolina's come out on the winning end each and every time and are still the lone undefeated team in all the nation and has the opportunity to get through two more games. They win them and be claiming yet another national championship, which, you know, South Carolina obviously feels like they let slip away a season ago when you fell to Iowa in the Final Four. But again, punch their ticket. They'll be on the road to Cleveland coming up this this weekend for the Final Four, taking on an NC State team who surprised a lot of people by getting past Texas in the in their Elite Eight matchup yesterday. And again, not necessarily a team that many people thought South Carolina was going to be seeing, because it really looked like we were shaping up to see all of the top four seeds make it in to the Final Four, which is something that only happened, or it happened, what, 19 times previously in women's basketball up to this point, as far as March Madness goes. So that's not going to happen with NC State getting past Texas in that weird situation where they had the three-point lines that were all kind of screwed up or whatever it was. But regardless, South Carolina taking on the Wolfpack coming up on Friday night. And then a couple of really intriguing matchups coming up later on this evening to wrap up Women's Elite Eight weekend, as you'll have LSU and Iowa. Very excited for that one, as I think the whole nation will be tuning in, as well as Southern Cal and UConn taking each other on later on tonight to determine who the other side of the bracket will be as far as the Final Four goes. And then got the games on Friday night, and winners will take each other on coming up on Sunday to crown a national champion. So South Carolina, once again, punching their ticket, fourth year in a row. And this is obviously something that means a lot to the team, and meets a lot to Dawn Staley, and continues to add to her already fantastic legacy here in Columbia at the University of South Carolina. We'll hear from her on what another trip to the Final Four does mean for her and for her program. As always, I want to remind you, you can check us out on The Game TV, sponsored by our friends at Shepherd's Glass. Go to YouTube.com. Search The Game TV. You can watch us all day long on all of our shows here, as well as check us out on the 107.5 The Game app. Just go to the Google Play Store or the iTunes Store, download the 107.5 The Game app. You can take us with you wherever you go, around the state, around the country, around the world. 107.5 The Game, always right there with you. Sound from